Hello and welcome to the Dropped Frames E3 coverage. I told you I was going to fix cameras once we get started. Dan, you got to use the special stuff. You got to like pull the green screen in. Just pull it in a little bit.
Yeah, I usually cut off the camera.
So. Yeah. There you go. We're just okay. We're good.
Dan, you're on Dropped Frames, the height of quality and perfection. You're on.
That's where we get television. Streamer advice, right? Yeah,
it is.
To get advice.
We get the top tip top key chroma key. Welcome. We're gonna cover some E3 stuff.
Kind of trailed up there.
Yeah. The kickoff live starts here in about 13 minutes. They've said that they're gonna go for a little under 2 hours. Rehearsals were around, I think, 90 minutes plus. Under 2 hours though, still. So we'll see. We'll see where they land in that. A lot of big world premieres about to happen. Everyone thinks that Elden Ring is going to occur. Elden Ring. What are the chances? What do we got? Where do you guys sit on the Elden Ring here? Is it happening? Is it a thing? Do we see it? Ko says no. Ko's in for no. Dan.
If they announce Elden Ring, I will play Final Fantasy 14 for you, and you can pick my cosmetics.
Pick your cosmetics? What is that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like you can pick what I look like.
But I want you to be your best self. Okay. Well, if I could pick, then I'll just say be your best. Okay. Great. Great. This is already a perfect day for me. I'm already very excited for the rest of the day. Zeke, where do you lie? Where do you sit?
Elden Ring is going to be shown. It's definitely going to be shown.
It's going to be there.
It's going to be here. We're going to see, like, it's going to be the best trailer you've ever seen. Calling it right here. Epic.
Zeke, I need a follow-up. Will there be gameplay?
No, there definitely will not be gameplay.
I'm doubling down.
It'll just be sizzle the whole time.
I'm doubling down. We're going to see Elden Ring. We're going to see gameplay. Today, it's happening. I think it's going to happen. That's where I'm at.
That would be huge.
What is that?
JP, how many subs you putting on the line? How many subs you putting on the line for this, JP?
Is this to my chat or is this to y'all or what's the bet here?
What is copium?
Copium?
Yeah.
I'll be needing some copium here if it doesn't show up.
Yeah.
There's also actually right now I've got a strong supply of hopium. I'll need some copium. After today, potentially. So you said gifted subs to my chat if it doesn't show up.
So we'll do. I will gift you two 50 subs if whoever wins, the other two has to gift them 50 subs.
Well, we all had different predictions, right?
Exactly. So whoever is right, the other two gift them 50 subs.
I'm in.
Okay.
All right.
Wait a minute.
No, it's too late.
No, hold on.
No, that was fine. Done.
No. So, Ko and Dan, did you say no show?
I said I will vote that it will be shown. It will be shown.
Do you think there'll be gameplay?
Okay.
I think trailer, no gameplay.
So me and Dan are in the same camp.
So me and JP can do 25 to each of you if that's the case.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Because I have worse odds because I doubled down and Ko doubled down as well that it's not going to be there. So the odds are in your favor, right? I guess. This is way too confusing.
I don't know math. So yeah, I think it's a triple under 20, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
We need a bookie.
A bookie implies that it's illegal. We just need someone to keep track of this shit is what we need.
Mm-hmm. So all we need to know is... If it's not shown, we owe Ko 25. If it is shown with gameplay, we owe JP 25. Mm-hmm. If it's just shown, just a trailer or a teaser or something like that, all ours.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Me and you, buddy.
But then I'm half winning.
What's that?
There you go. But I'm like half winning at that point. But I still pay?
Yes.
You're either getting
100 subs or you're giving 100 subs.
What if we do half that? What if I do half what I owe you if it's shown but no gameplay?
No, all anybody's going to owe is 50 is at max, right?
Yes.
Because we're splitting our 25.
Right, but what I'm saying is if it's shown but there's no gameplay, I'm still half right.
No, you're not right.
No, you're not. You're all right or all wrong.
Damn it, I was hoping I could get it this
one. God damn it.
Absolutely not.
No, but you and Co stand to gain the most, right?
Sure. We're betting big. Okay, All right. There we go.
Okay.
It's set in stone.
All right, we're done.
Set in stone. Do you guys want to bet on what the first trailer is?
I don't.
It's too wild.
It's the wild card bet, baby. It's wild card.
Let's do one bet and we can just do guesses.
Okay.
I will say this. There is, I've now seen two separate PR firms talk about how many things that they are NDA'd about at this conference.
Yes.
So there, and one of them was like, you guys are not going to believe it kind of hype. So my guess is that it might be a curveball for our first trailer, because if they are this hyped about NDA stuff, it leads me to believe it's a really big deal.
Sure.
And if it's a really big deal, then there's a good chance they may try to wow us from it out the gate. Sure. So I think we might get a curveball. That would be my best guess for first trailer. It's going to be a curveball.
Okay.
Oh, no, it's not going to be Starfield. That's Bethesda Xbox.
Also, put on headphones so we don't get feedback. I forgot to mention that to you in the pre-show. Keighley, I think, said yesterday that right out of the gate, there's two or three like big announcements that they're starting with. So we might get something like straight into it, just start seeing some craziness. That Firaxis Marvel game could be here. I've also heard rumors that the Marvel game is a Marvel versus DC thing. Like a fighting game. So that could maybe show up. Elden Ring, obviously, very always rumored to be anywhere that a trailer is being shown. So that could be
here. My guess is a Kojima non-exclusive game, like something that's coming on all platforms.
Multi-plat?
Whoa.
Yeah, something from Kojima.
Okay.
That would make a lot of sense for Keighley, like that, you know, putting his buddy at the front. That would make a lot of sense. How about we do this, JP? Why don't we start with what we know is there? Because I don't know that.
Do we know? I don't know if anything has been confirmed, like outright.
Yeah, it's been a lot of just vagueness. Like, it's starting, but we don't know anything about it, really.
Oh, Borderlands. Well, no, the Borderlands thing is still a rumor, but it's Wonderlands is supposed to show up here. And that's either DLC for Borderlands 3 or a complete standalone.
You know, there's going to be Tarkov stuff.
But yes, that's right. Battle State's going to be here in some way. Yeah.
I like how somebody was talking about the opener, Path of Exile VR. That would be interesting.
It could be.
That'd be weird as fuck, dude.
The speed at which you move through those maps, that would be rather nauseating. Maybe a bit much.
It's a lot. I'm going to swap over to this so I can fix any oddities that need fixed. And it looks like it seems pretty all right.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, looks nice.
I'm a little close to Zeke, though. I don't want to be. Get away from me!
Hey, come here.
No!
Come here.
I'm going to shrink this thing up here in the top.
I just want to put my head on your shoulder.
There we go. Cool. That looks good. Is that a... okay. I'll just get rid of that over there. And then we'll be done. Looks great. Sounds great. I think we're ready.
We're ready, man.
We were having a conversation in my chat earlier. Is this E3 day negative one, day zero? Like, when does E3 start?
This is Keighley Con.
It officially starts Friday.
So it's day zero then?
No. Friday's... Wait.
Let's be real here. This is Summer Game Fest.
Right.
This is not E3. This is Geoff Keighley using his very well-known pronounced influence to do his own thing at E3. So I would say E3 is tomorrow, and today is KeighleyCon. This is his thing. And so KeighleyCon is the pre-convention for E3, which starts tomorrow. Honestly, in the direction we're going, I wouldn't be surprised if like either E3 reaches out to Geoff Keighley, especially because it's looking like a huge amount of people are watching this. or if they do like something more, as Rami loves to say, if they do something more synergistic next year, you know, where they kind of, that would be probably, I'm guessing, in the cards. Or if other companies just go to Keighley, to be honest, and he just starts like making his own kind of around this time online event.
Could be.
I think this is going to be replacing E3 eventually. Like E3 is going to fade out, and this will be the thing that replaces it.
Yeah. Well, it's like we talked about this on the show yesterday. Like E3 is just a bunch of live streams now, right? Like 2 years in a row. Like what? It's a little absurd. And I think like once the rest of the industry kind of realizes they don't have to spend all this money on physical booths and like whatever to get the message out about their product, then why the fuck would they, right? Like, I don't know. We'll see. It's an interesting thing. I think out of all, Dan, have you been to E3s before, like physical E3s? Did you go to any?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Massive lines just to play things briefly.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Not the best experience when it comes to sitting in lines, which actually got worse, I think, once they started letting the public in and not journos. So. Yeah, we've got some big salt bets on Elden Ring being there. Someone put 250K down on the salt. I don't know about y'all's channel if you got some predictions running. But
oh, yeah, mods, I do. Let's do it. Yeah. Let's do it. Let's get a big prediction going for this.
I've got
some big ones.
700,000 for yes, it will be shown. 400,000 for no, it won't be.
Yeah. Oh, I was talking one person bet 250,000.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what my all-in is right now. It's like 10 to 6. Co and Dan will probably have a lot more on the all-ins. But, yeah. Minute 20 out.
I'd love to see my boy Ken Levine there. It's
oh,
there's some little rumory buzz.
Sure, yeah.
Yep, dude, he's been real quiet. Like, that would be pretty cool to see him explode on the scene here. Here of the PC game show. Would be a good place, too. Warren Spector also, like, his project, System Shock 3, which I know a lot of people are excited for, it was kind of going under for a while. Like, things were not looking good for it. And then he did this big announcement that Tencent was coming in and essentially bankrolling the project and letting them do what they want with it. I don't think we've heard much since then, either. So it could be kind of cool if we got more info on that, too, at some point.
Sure. Yeah. Trying to sync up the streams. Okay, good. I have 3 streams open for fail safes, so we'll see what happens. Should be good. Oh, also, how are you guys handling VODs for this weekend? Are we just deleting them across the board on all channels and putting them up on YouTube? Like what?
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
Yes.
Yeah, that's our. Yes. That's honestly, that's our standard fare these days.
Yeah, for everything. It's so dicey.
I know it's too risky anymore. Just to risk your whole channel on one DMCA.
Yeah. Yeah, it's insane. It's insane. All right, here we go. Let's see what they got to show. Please go ask your parents, chat, if you can watch.
Official channel is the Game Awards, right?
That's where I'm watching. Yeah. Great. Ooh, nice screen. Nice production.
I told you we'd start right on time. Hello, everyone around the world, and welcome to Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live, presented by Prime Gaming. I'm Geoff Keighley, and buckle up because we've got a big show for you filled with new game announcements, world premieres, updates on the games you play every day, some surprises, and special guests including Jeff Goldblum, Giancarlo Esposito, and performances by Weezer, Japanese Breakfast, and the Sonic the Hedgehog Symphony Orchestra. Yes, what? That's really a thing. Now, like a great video game, there may be some twists along the way today.
I like everything there, but music performances.
You see what we have planned for the end game.
You don't want to watch
that
the Sonic performance?
I'm allowed to tell you right now.
I don't watch any
this
of these
is just
things
the
for
start
music, man.
Of a big Summer Game Fest weekend of news and updates for fans, including live-streamed events from publishers like Xbox and Bethesda, Square
Enix,
Ubisoft,
I'm guessing.
And more. You can head right now to summergamefest.com to track all the events.
Yeah.
And believe me, there is a lot of great stuff coming your
does
way.
Live performance fall under DMCA?
But today,
I don't
we
know.
Kick
I
things
think
off
they were
with
out
a
there saying,
big 90-minute cross-industry showcase
that it's not going
to
be DMCA
or something. Platforms and rivalries aside, we will have updates and news for you no matter if you play on Nintendo Switch, PC, PlayStation, or Xbox. The Zeke, biggest games in the world will be here.
No, I'm not muted.
And some of the smallest ones, too.
He's just wrapped with anticipation.
I was fixing my windows. Around the world
who represent what's next. Thank you so much for tuning in and kicking off Video Game Summer.
Hey, what's here that Prime Gaming thing let's begin behind him? What is
with
that?
With a brand new game announcement.
They said that
you're
earlier.
You're about to see Amazon the world just premiere of the next great adventure from Gearbox and 2K.
Gearbox.
Oh.
Ooh.
What?
Ooh.
World premiere.
Exclusive.
Godfall 2.
No, this is the Tiny Tina stuff. Has to be.
Raid Shadow Legends.
Yep, Borderlands.
Fate. Oh, yeah.
It soars on the wind. It rises from the grave.
Wait, are they doing another D&D?
It stops. Yeah, yeah, it's the Tiny Tina DLC, so... Or a standalone game.
You cannot hide from fate.
That's definitely Borderlands, man.
But you can make your own.
Dude, I'm going directly to the feed, and yours is ahead of mine.
Really?
Any sandbags?
What the hell?
What?
Yeah. What?
Nice.
Oh, this is
BoJack Horseman.
Yeah, Tiny Tina.
Tiny Tina.
Oh, butt stuff. So it's completely standalone.
Wonderlands.
Roll for initiative, I hear her. Sucker!
Yep. They did a D&D DLC that was very good.
It was the best DLC for the game.
Yeah. It really is a full game.
Yeah, that's...
Full game.
Huh, okay.
Tiny Tina's Wonderlands is official, and joining us now is Tiny Tina herself, Ashley Burch. Hey, Ash, how you
What's
doing?
What's up, baby? How you doing?
Great to have you here.
You sound so much like
I
Elspeth.
Think the big question everyone's going to have is... What is Wonderland? What can you tell us about it?
It's a great question. Yeah. It's a high fantasy take on a looter shooter, as you saw. And if you're a fan of Borderlands, you'll probably recognize some fantasy elements inspired by Assault on Dragon Keep, which was the Borderlands 2
There's
DLC that was
that
beloved
room.
By the devs. And so this kind of inspired Wonderlands.
Now, I think the elephant in the room is this a Borderlands game? Is it not? How does it relate?
So it actually isn't. It's its own standalone game. And people that love Borderlands are going to find lots of elements to love about Wonderlands, but it's its own thing. Tiny Tina's got her own thing going on now. So it's got its own mechanics. Oh. There's spell casting. You can customize your character this time, which is super exciting. And if you love Borderlands, you're going to find stuff to love in this. And
most
if you've never
you
played
$60
Borderlands
for a standalone.
Okay, well, Tiny Tina gets her own game, which is fantastic. Yes. What is her role? Why does she get her own game?
So she is your bunker master. Yeah. She is kind of guiding the narrative and changing it on a dime if she wants. And she's just taking your cast of characters, which is an amazing cast, through this wacky world. And she's taking you on an adventure to defeat the Dragon Lord.
Actually excited about this. I'm actually pretty hyped to play this.
Voice cast, including you in this, which is awesome. So feels like such a big experience. So this was a bit of a tease, announcing it's out there. When will we find out more about this game?
Hopefully this summer. Yes. And you can find out a lot more at playwonderlands.com if you'd like.
Okay.
But yeah, just stay tuned for updates.
All right, coming early 2022. So
yes.
Tell me
next year. Ash, thank you so
no
much for joining us
trap.
In person.
Thanks for having me.
Appreciate it.
And, you'll have
you see the robot
right
on the right
now.
There?
Yeah.
Right, you see that?
Well,
that was,
now it is time for another brand new game announcement. This one you
That's
probably
tap,
are not
clap.
Expecting. A classic 90s franchise is coming back to life as a grid-based tactical strategy title for Steam on PC.
Really?
This is an insanely fun trailer.
Is this Marvel Alliance made by Firaxis or something?
World premiere.
Oh, no, not at all.
SNK.
I love this trailer already.
Wait a second.
Is it Metal
what?
Slug?
What? It's Metal Slug.
Oh, wow.
That's badass. Metal Slug's getting like a grid-based XCOM thing.
That's so cool.
I'm into it.
Ooh.
Sign me up.
This was like the arcade game for years. Like, oh, yeah. In the movie theater, you always got a couple games of Metal Slug.
Never beat it, though, because it was so hard.
Oh my god, did they have the original audio? Totally on board. Totally on board.
This trailer is hype as fuck, though.
This is a very good trailer.
We're only 7 minutes into this. This is already amazing.
It's like the same graphics and everything. That's so good.
I wonder if these little, like, animated cutscenes will be actually in the game.
Yeah. Oh, I hope so.
I hope so.
Me too.
Hope that's how they push the narrative, right?
Okay, we have another big announcement for you from a surprise guest, but it's well past 3 a.m. their time. So don't worry, we chatted earlier, and I'm very excited to share this with you right now. Hello, mystery guest.
What? Of course, man. Yeah.
Tim? Mr. Kojima, it is so good to see you. Thank you for joining us from Tokyo. First of all, I just want to ask, how are you doing? How are you feeling? How are things right now over there in Japan?
Alright, Kojima, let's keep it light. Let's keep it happy. Alright, let's
talk about video games, please.
Video games, Kojima, what are
we
working on?
Certainly hope that you're going to get your vaccine soon. Let me ask you, as a creator, how has this past
year impacted
you?
Tell us about your game!
We're blocking the old subtitles.
Yep. 今自分がいる世界を見て、で、地続きで5年後、10年後、20年後どうなるかっていうのを考えながら、そこにエンターテインメントを加えていって、まあ、作ってたのが結構その10年後、20年後に当たってたりっていうのはあったんですけど、今回のDSに関してはもう発売直後になったので、ちょっとかなりものの考え方が変わったというか、ものづくりのスタンスがちょっと変わったというか、 いろいろ考えました。今後のものづくり、やっぱりエンターテインメントである以上、楽しんでもらって、デス・ストランディング、イット・ジャスト・ワズン・ファン。プレイヤーのためになるものを作りたいっていうんですけど、こんなにも早くこう時代が追いついてくると、ちょっとこう、なんていうんでしょうね、フィクションじゃなくなってしまうので、で、なんで今回のコロナの中で、 この先をどう作るかっていうのはいろいろ考えましたね。他のクリエイターも多分大きく考えていると思いますが、911の時と同じような感じだと思いますね。これからエンタメをどういうふうに切り取っていくかっていうのはやっぱり大きな課題ではありますね。
Well, I know we are all very curious about
people telling us to be quiet during that. You don't speak Japanese. You don't understand him. Imagine like we were interrupting him.
I don't know how much you can say, but can you give us any sense of kind of where your mind's at right now, what you're thinking about, some of the themes or the ideas?
Smells kind of like bullshit blazing. Coming out of his mouth right now.
Jesus Christ, man!
Let's hit on everything.
Let's
go existential.
Odds
that he's going to mention like the heat death of the universe or something like.
Our son is dying.
Yeah, wait at the end of this for him to be like, so we've combined Metal Gear Solid and Pachinko, and we've come up with a new game.
そこはすごく神経質になってます今。
All right, Fair enough. I tried. Well, Mr. Kojima, honestly, I really do appreciate you making the time to stop by and just say hello to everyone. We miss you, and we can't wait to see what you're working on next.
Just having a chat.
That's it?
Just having a chat.
You're not going to show what he's working on?
One more thing.
Oh, here we go. Here's one more thing.
Okay.
Baited.
Death Stranding DLC?
Son of a bitch.
Ooh. PS5.
I'm leaving.
Oh, Death Stranding for PS5.
I was hoping it was going to be something else.
Yeah.
That's new, though. This is new.
Oh, this is an interior.
I know. Don't care.
Wait.
It hurt me too bad.
Can you go inside the buildings now?
He literally just made Metal Gear Solid Death Stranding.
Dude, that'd be, I'm on board with that.
Yeah, I would have no complaints.
I'd love to see him sneaking around with that massive ass backpack on.
That's not the right thing.
We're adding a new battle royale mode to Death Stranding.
Is that Master like Chief? Flappy Predator.
Yeah, dude, the ribbon hair. I think we can. Thank you, JP.
Yeah, I fumbled the. I went horizontal instead of vertical the first click.
Where's his back?
Do you think this is the Metal Gear Solid?
Just like,
you think Metal Gear Solid Remastered?
In a box.
What if this is a?
He's gonna hide in a box.
What if this is Metal Gear Solid Remastered?
No. Oh God, please. Oh, don't do that.
He's doing it.
This is a jibay. It's got to be a jibay, right?
Oranges.
What could I do with this? I could get inside the box. No, don't do it.
No, not
He's
like
gonna
this.
Do it.
I think don't I need it. To turn it over.
Do you think they motion cap Norman Reedus just staring at a box?
What if I got in the box?
But how will I move like this? The ground is solid. Oh my God, they're actually doing this.
He's gotta think about how to do it properly.
If it fits, I
No one just got under the box right away.
This box won't work. It would be upside down. I need a bigger box. Fucking what? Oh, bless
Director's
you.
Director's cut.
Bless you, Kojima.
What the
Wait,
fuck?
What? He didn't get his...
Means.
He didn't get final say on this...
Branding? They're thinking outside the box!
Oh, boo. Boo this man, chat.
Boo.
Boo him.
There you have it. Death Stranding Director's Cut finally confirmed. I hope I make it into the Director's Cut. I'm told the full reveal is just weeks away.
Geoff.
Stay tuned. Right, next, it's my honor to welcome to Summer Geoff. Game Fest a legendary actor who dedicated a whole episode of his Disney Plus show to exploring the world of gaming and has been in games like Call of Duty Black
that
Ops
was
3.
Really weird.
And we're
Goldblum.
Thrilled
yeah,
to have him
weird.
Here
that,
at Summer Game
that whole
Fest.
Kojima section
Geoff
was
Goldblum,
weird.
How are you, my friend?
Yeah. Just gonna say it.
It was very Kojima.
Thank you
though.
So much, Joffrey or Geoff or sorry, I think it's Geoffrey. Hey, maybe it's Geoff. Hi, Geoff. Thank you so much, sincerely, for having me here. I'm thrilled to be here. Hey, I was watching your show, and I was wondering if there might be some video game. World premieres, as you say. And sure enough, yeah.
Like an alien saying English words for the first time.
Yes, we do like our world premieres around here. Any chance you brought one with you today?
Well, it's funny you should say that. Yes, you could say yes, I do. If you don't mind, I've got something here. I'm going to read it on this. There's a little bit of a teleprompter that they're putting up here. So I'm going to read something because I don't want to get it wrong. I'm very meticulous about this. So here's a dramatic reading of this game announcement. Ready? I'm going to make the game announcement right
I
now.
I love this guy so much.
Hello. Uh-huh. I'm here to welcome you to a very different world. It's going to elevate you to new heights. It's going to submerge you to new depths. Maybe even challenge you to control chaos. Actually, it's going to certainly challenge you to control chaos. It's a world so-called evolved. Oh, take a look at the, you guessed it, world premiere.
Hey, you motherfucker!
Great. Bravo.
He needs to do more of
what do you
want to
bet?
That was great.
What do you want to bet Jeff Goldblum is not only a shoes-off house when you go to visit him, it's like a clothes-off house. You got to take your clothes off at the door before you walk.
I think this is Jurassic Park Evolution 2 or whatever, right?
That's what we were saying yesterday. Like it was a toy.
Yeah, he did do voiceover for that.
We weren't careful. And now, here we are.
I might mute. That's like kind of DMCA territory right there.
A very different world.
Here we are.
I think I'm about to get eight.
I actually muted that.
Ooh.
I don't want to be DMCA for that one. Is it still playing? Is there still a theme?
No, it's not. No. It's done.
Okay.
Did they title drop?
Yeah, yep. Jurassic Park World.
World Evolution 2.
Yeah.
A World of All.
Jurassic Evolution.
Okay.
All right, this performer's new album, Jubilee, is out now, and her book, Crying in H-Mart, is a New York Times bestseller. Here now to perform Glider.
Are we muting? What do you think?
Open world game Sable by Raw Fury and Shedworks.
Oh, it's game
Japanese
music.
Breakfast.
It's game music.
Okay.
I think we're okay.
Yeah.
That is a really awesome room that they are in, production wise.
Just a giant.
Yeah, that is badass.
That looks so cool.
Oh, the ground's a screen too.
Oh yeah, it all is.
I don't know about breakfast, but she here sure is a snack. Oh, am I right? Can I get nobody?
She's okay, very
shut up. I'll shut up now.
Have you guys played Sable? Is that out
now?
Alpha. Okay.
Dig it. Very comic booky. Like, I'm trying to think of the comic book it reminds me of. Like, Saga, maybe?
A little bit, yeah.
Pod racing.
Oh, that gets a laugh. Mine does. Oh my god, I see what.
Well, he's not gonna get us canceled by saying that, right?
Nailed it. Is that cancel worthy?
I don't.
Looks like a
100%. I just actually got the email.
Okay. I formally apologize. The views held by Zeke do not reflect the views held by Drop Frames Incorporated.
Oh, yeah, someone said Banner Saga. It looks very Banner Saga.
Good call. Yeah. I'm adding that emote immediately to my channel.
Before moving would give me motion sickness.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so I think this is the same technology that they used when they made The Mandalorian. Like the digital projection stuff. As far as musical performances go, that wasn't that bad.
That was
in terms of being like a game performance.
So beautiful.
Musical performance at a game show.
Sable will be released on September 23rd this year. That's some news for you. And to learn more about this amazing game, watch the Tribeca Game Showcase. That is tomorrow, where Sable was named an official selection of the Legendary Festival. Now, today is just the start of Summer Game Fest. Day of the Devs with I Am 8-Bit and Double Fine will immediately follow the live show today. And there are more events coming all weekend and all month, including the Xbox and Bethesda Games Showcase on Sunday. It's going to be a good one. Right now, though, we're thrilled to announce the upcoming Western release of a spectacular 3D, massively multiplayer online role-playing game.
Okay, this is weird. Is Summer Game Fest
E3? Welcome to the world of Lost Ark.
Yeah, that's what I'm...
Smilegate RPG.
He just claimed, like, Microsoft and Xbox Showcase was Summer Game Fest.
Yeah.
Not E3.
Yeah.
I don't know.
They're collabing.
Also, what did they just say? Lost Ark is coming to the U.S. Was that the announcement?
Yeah. We've heard about this.
Yeah.
Not that it was coming to the U.S. I thought that was the first. Was Amazon always behind this?
Yep. Well, they weren't, but now they are.
But now, our world has been torn once again.
Well, regardless, this game looks awesome. So.
The demons. Yeah. Looks gorgeous for an
MMO. Very cool. Looking forward to this one big time.
Just like I was talking about fucking yesterday, Ark is one of those, is going to be one of those words, I'm guessing.
Maybe.
One of those buzzwords that everything uses.
Yeah.
Yeah, back when this game was like, there was that period of time when this game was going around Twitch.
Yeah.
Because of like a Russian invader or something.
Korea.
Dude,
yeah.
That, I think that's the most I've ever watched of streams that I didn't speak a single word of the language. Like, I would just hang out in the streams watching people play this game, and it actually looked really cool.
Yeah.
Is this like an action RPG MMO?
Yes.
Yeah, it's an ARPG MMO.
The, really cool. The boss fights are like pretty challenging, and you like zone into them just like you would like a WoW boss fight.
And what's nice about this game is it's already done, and it's already good. All Amazon's doing is bringing it over. So yeah. It's like, yeah.
Yeah, it's very exciting. Uh-oh, Chad. We've got field reporter Potato Field saying Elden Ring just updated their YouTube playlist.
Uh-oh.
What does it mean?
Elden Ring confirmed.
I just want to take a moment right now to bless all the Uber nerds out there. Bless you. Bless you. I love that someone's just sitting there watching it going like refreshing them. Oh, playlist. They did something.
Sometimes when you play a game, there's that one thing in your inventory which turned out to be far more useful than you first realized. That's kind of like Prime Gaming. If you're an Amazon Prime member,
there's a tester sign up, by the way.
You get a ton of gaming goodies every month. This month, you can download Battlefield 4 and Batman the Telltale series completely free for PC, and there are special in-game benefits and perks.
Hashtag
GTA Online, Valorant, Apex Legends, and more that you can unlock. It's awesome value, and honestly, this kickoff show would not have been possible without the Prime Gaming folks believing in my vision for a new way to bring you the news this summer.
Very true.
Head over to gaming.amazon.com to check out all the perks and free games, which change every month, but you get to keep them.
None of us motherfuckers want to pay for this shit, so someone's got to.
I wish it gave you like a free Twitch Prime sub every month or something as well.
That would be insane.
The value. Yeah. That would take like $5 off your Prime subscription.
And then people would forget, so we would actually make money
right
off
now,
of those
I'm
suckers
to be joined
if they
by
forget
Johanna
to use their Prime Gaming
sub. GM of Call of Duty. Johanna, it's so great to have you with us here on Kickoff Live. Everyone is so excited about what Call of Duty has been doing.
Yeah, Doc,
if
you go to playlostark.com, you can sign up there to
like
test
next
it.
Week, June 17th. Season 4?
Yes, we're super excited. We're super honored to be here. So thank you first and foremost.
I think this was
confirmed
to be
here. It's just such an amazing time for Call of Duty. We're experiencing such transformational growth and dynamism across the entire brand, you know, from premium title releases to everything we'll talk about today, with Warzone, with mobile, with esports.
Or wait, I guess it wasn't this person.
Super incredible, all the work, and shout out to everybody
in the Call
of Duty
League's got some issues.
Makes it happen every day.
last day or two.
I mean, I know season three, it was like, you know, Rambo, Die Hard. Now, who knows what's in store for season four? But you guys, you know, continually update the game now with new stuff. Season four is coming next week. What can you, this is first info on it, so what can you tell the fans watching around the world?
Yeah, we're stoked. It's jam-packed with new content.
Oh, boots.
Across Cold War and Warzone. You know, you've got new weapons, we've got new maps, we've got badass new operators. I'm super excited about the hijacked gulag. We've got expanded zombies content for everybody who loves that part of, you know, the gameplay experience. So we're thrilled, and I'm excited to bring it forward a little bit here today.
I know, we've got the first look world premiere trailer of season four. So
is that guy's eyes moving, or is that just because it's a curved screen that looks like he was staring at you?
Like one of those paintings in a museum.
Yeah.
Do what you are told, and you get to live.
What the fuck? You put me in a game.
I knew you were a smart one.
And
are you getting royalties?
Well, I'm dead.
Secure the site.
Actually, it looks like a JP Dan combo.
A little bit.
I'm so ready for that Battlefield gameplay. Oh my god.
I feel like Captain America here. I'm just like, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Raptor 1, my team's about to be overrun.
Game makes a lot of money still, very popular.
Death.
You can shit on it all you want, but it is, in a lot of ways, the most expensive cockroach of video games. We'll always be here.
When are we gonna?
So fun, and 1 week away.
Stop calling them gamers.
All right, well, let's move
on. They're not gamers
anymore. You play one game. They're game. Call of Duty esports, and we're gonna talk a little bit now about what is the world.
You just made the argument we should be called
Warzone,
gamesers.
Which is gonna start on
gamesers. There you go.
We're gamesers.
First of all, tell us what is World Series Warzone.
Yeah, we're super excited about it. It's really a new way for us to highlight competitive Call of Duty. You know, we've got great success going with Call of Duty League. Now we've got some of the biggest names in gaming battling it out in Verdansk for what will be the biggest prize pool in Warzone since it's launched, right? So we'll talk a little bit about what that entails, but custom lobby experiences, 150 player to a side squad. So I'm stoked to see how they kind of rally here in Verdansk.
Yes, and coming up very soon, June 22nd, looks like Twitch Rivals is going to be a part of this?
Yeah, we are honored to be in partnership with Twitch, always, right? But certainly here with World Series of Warzone and partnering with Twitch Rivals, who's already done so much to really put competitive Warzone on display. So couldn't be in better partnership there, and we're excited to have everybody tune in.
Yes, there is one thing, though, that everyone has been talking about online, and that's who the captains are going to be for the structure of the World Series of Warzone, at least for the first event.
Yeah.
I understand we've... getting a little bit reveal here of who some of the captains are.
Yeah, we love the first five captains of the first of many events.
I know that person is.
Like I said, these are huge influencers and personalities in Call of Duty.
I don't know that guy. I think he's a smaller streamer.
For competitive Call of Duty, right? They really
believe he's a huge streamer.
What is the promise of World Series of Warzone and to really level up what it means to really battle it out. So couldn't be happier with some of these names. Many of whom also hail from the Call of Duty League family.
Timothy Atman, I think is his name.
I was going to say, they're all battling out in just a couple weeks on Twitch Rivals. Well, it's really exciting to see how much Call of Duty is growing.
No, it's Tim Theta T-Man.
Year-round experience.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure that's it.
We can't wait to see where you're going to take it. And I know there is a big new mainline game coming later this year.
Tim Theta
T-Man. Indeed, indeed. More details to share later on.
So they just said that this is the biggest prize pool ever for
truly incredible.
Call of Duty or for Warzone?
All right, we tried.
Call of Duty Warzone.
There will come a time and a place for that. All right, Johanna, thank you so much for joining us.
Because if it's more than like the COD esports, I wonder how the pros feel that like influencers are about to make more money.
We've got a surprise guest joining us.
When they barely play the game as much as they do.
Ryan Reynolds. Hey, Ryan.
Well, thank you,
Ryan Reynolds.
Are we going to get a movie trailer?
Game Fest.
Is it going to be Deadpool?
Probably.
I know what you're
I think it's the movie trailer for Free Guy.
I'm not here to announce I'm the star of Elden Ring. I think. Instead, I'm making. I'm here to talk about good old-fashioned movies. You remember those things?
I can't believe you said.
Of course you don't. Look, I have a new movie coming out August 13th called
Ninja
Free Guy.
Ninja and Pokemon are in this movie. If they play the trailer, I am going to mute and probably not show it.
Video game. Until I break free and I realize that it kind of sucks to be a lonely background character on an endless walk cycle. So Now here's one of those world premieres.
You look so good.
It's a first ever look at our cast on the big screen this August. And honestly, it's been so long I can't even remember who's even in this movie. I didn't say that. I'll cut that out. Yeah, I'll do it right now.
My name is Guy.
I thought I had everything I needed. That's wrong. I don't want to get DMCA'd for showing a movie trailer.
Oh, yeah, they're full on playing that.
Yeah, it's
I'm
Mariah
in heaven
Carey.
With my boyfriend.
It's Mariah Carey. Yeah, I think.
Mariah Carey covered a different song. I'm not sure which version it is.
Yeah.
Oh, now they're doing The Who.
Great. This is all perfect for mm-hmm. me to not show.
Out here in the fields.
No one would ever mistake that for The Who. So
I think
we're okay.
Should be far enough away from
Roger Daltrey. Is this Truman Show except a game instead of a dome?
Yeah, like he's in a video game.
Yeah, yeah. He's an NPC in a video game where people, like real people.
Yeah. Oh.
And your favorite Twitch streamers, Pokimane and Ninja, who was just on screen, are in it.
Ninja has a cameo. Oh, good.
I think Zeke has me
muted. Wonderful. Actually, a lot of influencers are on this.
I think they all have me muted, Jet.
There's a lot of streamer cameos in this.
Mm-hmm.
If only someone was saying that multiple times.
No, they actually do. They show streams and YouTube
seeing,
videos
Ninja,
and stuff
Pokey,
from.
Jacksepticeye,
I'm guessing familiar faces.
Will be in Free Guy. Ryan had to say it. I can't say it yet. All right. Up next, it won multiple awards at the Game Awards, and Among Us just keeps going. Now it's time to hear from Inner Sloth on what's coming next.
What is Inner Sloth?
The makers of Among Us?
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Am I choppy on your stream, JP? Like, is my camera choppy?
I don't think so.
I didn't see.
Okay. Is this game still massive?
It's starting to slow
it's
down.
It's actually really popular with kids.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I just didn't know if it was starting to, like, die.
A lot of the big influencers said they're stopping content on it until there's new content to cover, but it's still popular player-wise.
Dude, I followed, once I found out who was going to be in the new D&D show, I followed Chilled Chaos, and this is, like, his, I would say, it's like his main game.
His best friend, buddy.
Dude, thousands and thousands
of
every day.
Lots of fun ahead. Great. And speaking of Among Us, last year you may remember the very rare Geoff Keighley mask was available as a Twitch drop around the Game Awards, never to be seen again. In fact, I often hear on Twitter from people who get booted from games with the mask because folks think that they're hacked. Well, never fear. Today, the mask is back. Just head to Twitch, connect your account, and watch 15 minutes or more of Kickoff Live.
I think this is enabled on
Geoff Keighley mask
my channel.
Once again, and then it goes back into
the vault. He tweeted out a form that you could put your channel on, and I think it got approved.
Speaking of independent developers, now I'm very happy to welcome Summer Game Fest, the head of indies at PlayStation,
all five of you,
a legend in his own right, who has some exciting things to share, Shuhei Yoshida. Hi, Shu.
Thanks, Geoff. Hi everyone, I'm Shuhei Yoshida, head of PlayStation Indies. What I love about working with independent developers are the new and unexpected games that they create, which allows us to offer an array of unique experiences for players. In my role at Sony, it's very exciting to get to meet with these talented studios, which sometimes can be one person or a small group of friends, to help nurture the ideas and bring them to the PlayStation fans. One example is from Finji, who has been working with Greg Lobanov, the developer of Wonder Song, to publish their new game, Chicory, A Colorful Tale. Chicory released today and gives players the chance to experience a coloring book-style world where players use their painting powers to explore, solve puzzles, make friends, and draw on anything. Check out Chicory, A Colorful Tale on PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 after the show. As a huge Soulsborne games fan, I totally enjoyed the beautiful 2D action-adventure Salt and Sanctuary a few years ago. The developer Ska Studios has been hard at work on a new title, which I'm proud to present to you, Salt and Sacrifice.
Really? Salt and Sanctuary was awesome.
Ooh. Our sins will catch up with us.
Damn. Yeah, it does look better. Man.
Always.
Co, did you finish this?
I finished Blasphemous, but I don't think I finished Salt and Sanctuary.
I was given
maybe?
A second
I don't remember. I remember liking it.
I spoke the words.
Dan, did you finish it?
I don't think so, because I think some other big game came out at the same time, and I got caught up with that one. I remember this was very good, though.
Yeah.
I live
very,
now.
Very hard.
This looks so much more refined. Mages.
Whoa.
I played a couple hours of it, and it just, like, it seemed like it would be for me, but it just wasn't. I don't really care for, like, the marionette animation.
I am a marked inquisitor. There aren't many of us.
But together, we will take
oh,
wow. the chaos.
Oh,
oh. Oh.
Apparently, there is an Elden Ring pre-order on Amazon.
What? Nani?
Thanks, Shu. And that's
unless
not
I
all.
Just got
today,
one
we're
guy.
Also able to share with you a brand new trailer from the upcoming
yes,
Annapurna and Heart Machine game, Solar Ash, which is coming to PlayStation later this
is
year.
Is it collector's edition or no?
Asking for a friend, JP?
Maybe. I mean, are we judging each other now, Co? Is that what's happening?
Yep.
No, I would pick it up in
4 pre-order now.
I do not see collector's edition.
No.
Not yet.
What is this game? Sorry, I was Elden Ring, you know.
Even on the official Bandai store.
Oh, this is Solar Ash.
And has that Lost Colossus look to it?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm all for it, man. If I like the original game, go ahead, make lots of copies.
Yeah.
I would like those too.
There's a reason cliches work.
Also from chat, there was also a hidden video in a FromSoft playlist,
so
but as soon as people saw
year.
It, they
now,
deleted it.
Now, this week,
it.
There is a ton of video game news, but there's also a big game launching across console
that page
and
like
PC,
crazy.
Chivalry 2, which brings 64-player multiplayer medieval
Ring,
battles
really.
To life.
Hard to say.
Sledgehammers, swords, axes, you name it,
dude,
and it comes from Blood Banner Studios in my
Shadow
hometown
of the Colossus,
in Toronto, Canada.
Like, game
here's a look
had,
at the launch trailer
like,
for Chivalry 2, which you can play right now.
Fury music?
Because how does how's this launch
just
going?
Tweeted,
so?
Oh, you don't
go
want
ahead.
To miss the grand finale.
Oh,
there's okay. The grand finale at the end that you don't want to miss.
Gotcha.
That?
Keighley did.
That's prior level do out of the ring.
Because the launch has gone well.
It's been pretty good. There have been a few hiccups here and there, but overall it's been good.
Really hard to play.
Oh, it actually made it a lot easier to play, like more kind of stuff. It's a lot of fun. I've been really enjoying it.
Yeah, I was able to be okay at it, Dan. And so I usually hate these games because of that. So you might want to check it out. It's fun just to cut someone's
really
head
hard
off.
To control.
Yeah, it's pretty approachable.
This is Sparta.
Oh, so you can Black Knight it. That's pretty neat. You have both your arms missing and just kick.
Just one, unfortunately.
Oh, just one, okay.
Yeah, you die after a certain amount of time. But...
Who's Agatha?
A dude. One of the sides.
He's like a faction leader that died.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of screaming in that game, by the way.
Oh, yes. I'm playing that tonight, actually.
This nice. Month, Valorant from Riot celebrated its one-year anniversary, and starting next Monday, June 14th, Prime Gaming members will get an exclusive player card to celebrate the one-year anniversary. and a pity party spray through June 25th. This is all leading up to the release of Episode 3 of the game later this month.
What game is
which
this?
Which will be celebrated Valorant? With an epic WW Fest Unlocked Year 1 stream on June 25th. Woo. But there will also be a new agent. Who could it be? Well, here's your first very, very exclusive but very, very quick tease to whet your appetite with more to be revealed later this month during Summer Game Fest.
It's a robot.
Ooh.
He looks cool. That was very fast. Holy shit.
Yeah, they weren't kidding. Wow. I
told you it was very, very quick.
You did, Geoff.
All right. Warring PMC factions face off against each other in Escape from Tarkov, the
popular
multiplayer first-person shooter video game developed by Battlestate Games. Today, we've got an exclusive new look at the streets of Tarkov, the new area of the game under development.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, damn.
That looks great.
I wonder how many windows of those are actual real windows that I'm going to have to look at.
Oh, I'd be so paranoid.
Oh, there's a lot.
Ooh.
Holy shit.
Such a good job with these levels.
That looks really
good. Dude, it totally looks like Pripyat.
Yeah.
That is so cool looking.
You think they'll do a wipe for this, Co?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
All right, Tarkov's back on the menu.
I'm pretty much waiting for this wipe to get back in, probably. Also, since we've played JP, they've redone customs. They have a factory rework on the way.
Nice. Like,
there's a lot of new good stuff. A lot of great updates, bug fixes.
I never played this on the track, but it looks complicated.
It's a lot.
It is complicated, and it's a lot, but it's one of those things where it's totally worth putting the time in. What you get out of it is a lot of fun, especially as a looter like yourself. I think you'd really enjoy this game.
It is an FPS.
I gotta
though.
Say, game dev, when I was interviewing game devs and shit, the game devs for this shit, like before it became anything, I got a chance to sit down with them and thought they are fucking the most intense like game devs like I've ever sat down with.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe it's because of where they come from. Maybe it's because of the game. But, like, these dudes are, like, all about this shit. And that's all. And
they know their shit.
It's kind of intimidating.
Yeah. Yeah, Dan, I think the best thing about being a streamer and playing this game is chat can teach you how to play.
Yeah,
it's really not approachable. Unless you're watching a lot of guides, but as a streamer, you have a privilege where chat will.
What was that?
That was an APC.
Is that a
with
boss riding in or something?
No, I don't know.
Looked like it.
There are bosses in the game, by the way, Dan.
That's
like
cool.
Rare spawns and stuff.
Yeah, that must have been like a boss coming in or something. That was crazy cool.
I don't want to fight an APC, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, not on the to-do list.
When I was a kid, the simulation games of Peter Molyneux were some of my favorites. Adding that extra salt on the fries in the theme park to increase your drink sales was so devilish. Well, many of the team members behind those sim games went on to create Two Point Studios and Two Point Hospital. Well, today we're excited to share the first trailer for their next Two Point simulation, Two Point Campus.
Ooh. This was leaked a while back.
That first sight of the school gates, the scent of a leather-bound book, the faint clatter of knights jousting. Well, I can't say I remember that part, though it wasn't like this in my
game. These devs
day.
Are really good, so
you
this
see,
is going to be great.
Campuses are forever changing. Nowadays, education has to be fun. It can't be all work and no play, and quite right, too. Apparently, the results speak for themselves. Academia has never been more appealing, more
We're only
dynamic,
45 minutes into this show.
Whatever this is.
This show's been
packed. Today's campus is a place
we
to
got,
live.
We got almost
and
another
a
hour.
To learn. Finally crafted by the sharpest
Like the nerd giving the jock wedgie there.
Though sometimes you still can't get the stuff.
yes, these days it really does feel as though anything is possible.
You put a lot of time in the other one, right, Dan? 2 Point Hospital?
Yeah, it's very fun if you liked Theme Hospital back in the day. Very fun sim games. I love the sim era of games. It brought me back to those moments.
Yeah. 2 Point Campus. Class is in session 2022.
Cool.
This year, I am thrilled to have Netflix as a part of Summer Game Fest. They have been doing an incredible job adapting games with series like Castlevania and the Dota anime. Well, there is a lot more coming, and you don't have to wait long to find out more. Tomorrow, I'm honored to be guest hosting Netflix's Geeked Week live stream with Mari Takahashi and Rahul Kohli. You can expect the first clip of the Cuphead show, which, spoiler alert, this show is going to be an absolute sensation. I can't wait for you to see it. I'll also sit down with the team behind Arcane, the League of Legends animated show coming later this year, and we might also have updates
what is Arcane
on The Witcher
be there for?
And the live-action Resident Evil series.
That's not our Arcane.
Is streaming live tomorrow at 9 a.m. Pacific.
They said Arcane
noon
behind
Eastern.
The Here's a little PUBG sneak peek. Animated thing or something.
Oh.
I don't think it's our Arcane.
What is Geeked Week? Netflix Geek is hosting a free virtual event full of big news.
Oh, Arcane is the League of Legends anime, so that'll be stupid
huge. Films you love on Netflix. Comics, games, movies, zombies, animation, sci-fi.
I think they released a new trailer today for Masters of the Universe, which I think is Netflix.
Witcher and much more.
People you love from the shows you love live. Grab your devices.
I wonder if we'll get a Witcher season 2 trailer tomorrow.
Netflix Geeked for Geeked Week. There's so much to get geeked about.
We aren't done with Netflix just yet, though. Coming up next is Smite, a cross-play, cross-platform game that continues to do some pretty amazing IP crossovers.
I haven't heard that game in a while.
Last summer, we announced the Avatar The Last Bender one.
It's been blowing up on YouTube.
Well, as Smite enters its ninth year, it's time to go upside down.
Oh, well, now they've got a Stranger Things deal. What? Oh, apparently said the last bender.
Yeah. These are 11. Skins for gods.
Oh, these are just skins? These aren't original characters?
Not that exciting, yeah.
Scylla and Bakakora.
Yeah, these are existing gods, but there's skins for them. It's where they make all their money for this game is from the skins.
Huh. Is it?
Kinda
is
like
it?
PoE.
Is it free to play?
It's free to play. Yep. And it's they
Next
have battle
up,
passes.
We announce a lot of games on my show, but I think this is the first time we are announcing an entirely new game label, new game publisher. Enjoy this first look at more than 12 games that make up its initial slate.
Wow. Okay.
Sometimes I ask myself what it all means. Let's begin.
That's the CEO. They've got some money.
Heyday.
That is Payday, right?
Is that who you are?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because this is a new publisher, so.
Looks like Kingdom Come.
Is that Kingdom Come? Yeah. There's a rumor that Kingdom Come Deliverance 2 was going to be announced.
It's going to be called Kingdom Came.
What is that game with the dual thing in the back of the bed?
Where others would fail.
Well done. Well done, Dan.
Some days I ask myself, why is Dan so popular on Twitch? And then shit like that happens and I go, why is Dan so popular on Twitch?
Codename Final Form?
That was a game.
Prime Matter.
Was it?
Oh, Prime Matter is the publisher. Okay. Great.
There you have it, Prime Matter, Payday 3-2, and there is actually one more game added to the mix. And for that, we go to Todd Hollinshead from Saber. Todd, how you doing?
I'm great, Geoff. Thank you for the intro there. I'm really excited to
have Saber Interactive.
Last edition, which is that Saber and Prime Matter are working together on a new game in the Painkiller franchise.
Okay.
Painkiller. Ooh,
all right, very cool on that. And there are more details on Prime Matter coming tomorrow with a stream at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, and I will be stopping by. Next up is a brand new IP from a brand new studio, Stray Bombay. It's coming this fall only to Xbox, PC, and Game Pass on day one. It's called The Anacrusis, a four-player cooperative first-person shooter set aboard a massive starship stranded at the edge of explored space. You team up with your friends in an infinitely replayable fight against alien hordes to unlock perks, weapons, and new ways to play that you can share with your team. Here is the world premiere trailer.
What is this? Left for Dead Space?
Yeah, that's okay. That's a good way to summarize what he just said, yeah.
Thanks for that, chat.
Hello? Nessa!
It's kind of praise. A little more. Okay.
That's a lot. Left 4 Dead style.
It really is Left 4 Dead.
This disco? This I do not like.
This looks kind of early.
This looks kind of indie. Yeah.
Yeah, those not good. Not good. Things aren't really looking what? Scary.
Is every single alien exactly the same?
It looks just like run. It.
No stopping, no shooting, just straight to the bridge.
I like how there was three different ways to say the same thing. I went with early, Co went with indie, and chat went with shit. So, you know, all of the...
Chat, you rude! Oh, come on.
We'd sound smart calling them brutes.
Chat is sometimes unkind. These? No, the game, sometimes. Brutes!
Huh. Who's the team behind that?
Awesome look. Thanks for that, Chet and the team at Stray Bombay.
Oh, Stray Bombay.
Summer Game Fest I'm trying
to figure out why
New World,
my shit's
new
so slow.
Open world MMO from Amazon Games set on the supernatural island of Eterno.
They're supposed to have
finally
a
coming out later
thing
this
tomorrow.
Summer, and in the deep dive video,
for like
game
an
director
hour.
Scott Lane will take players into the mysterious supernatural island that is a world of wonder and horror. Once you arrive, it's up to you to unite warring human factions to take on a common enemy, the Tempest, who wants to unmake life. Scott and the team will detail updates to the game, including new mid and end game content, more PvE and expeditions, five-player challenges with unique mechanics, bosses, loot, and more. Six of these expeditions will be at launch, with the closed beta on July 20th and the public launch on August 31st. I will also be down at the studio to chat with Scott about the game and the team's efforts over the past year in the midst of COVID. It is exciting for me to finally be able to get out there and visit game studios again. I miss all these developers. So check out the special deep dive stream on New World tomorrow at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern.
I'll be checking that out just to see what they have to say.
.com. All right, well,
I don't know if I'm hyped for that game at all.
Rocket
but...
League teamed up with Fast and Furious.
Curious.
Bringing some of the saga's most iconic cars into the game. And now they are back. With a twist that is truly Rocket League, with Fast 9, the next installment of the Fast saga, arriving in U.S. theaters June 25th. Psyonix is bringing back the Nissan Skyline, Dodge Charger, and, well, maybe the most literal, supersonic, acrobatic, rocket-powered heist car ever conceived, the F9 Pontiac Fiero.
I was hoping it was just Vin Diesel's head wrapped on a car or something. I'd buy that in a heartbeat.
Uh-huh.
think this is DMCA.
Like, are there yes. any,
real cars?
No, like movie vehicles they haven't done yet. Like, I'm sure they've done the DeLorean, Knight Rider. Like,
seems like the right idea to me. The Fast and Furious three-car bundle arrives June 17th in Rocket League. Okay, next up, last year, a new Swedish company named Shark Mob released a teaser for their first unnamed multiplayer project in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. Tonight, we're putting a name on their first game with a brand new world premiere trailer.
Ooh.
World premiere.
Has Shark Mob done anything else?
If they have, I couldn't tell you. Not off the top of my head.
For centuries, we have lived in secrecy among you, maintaining the masquerade.
Is this the V we Rising, have whatever?
Influenced your society. Uh-huh.
Oh, this is their first game, chat. Or, according to chat. Because wow. Geoff just said
you
that.
You really just mixed me up with chat, JP?
Look, they're both C's. Okay. Now.
I would love to see some gameplay of this.
Yeah.
Is it multiplayer?
I don't know.
Yeah, looks like a multiplaying fighter game.
Yeah. It's like they're battling each group.
Hey,
of players.
To be fair, what was that game called that was like Hunters versus Vampires? That was, I thought it was great. It was got shut down recently. Nazgoth. That game was awesome.
Yeah, that game was fun.
That game was fun. I would. Oh, Vampire Blood Hunt. Okay.
So it isn't the Vampire Hunters. I wasn't
actually
sure.
Actually, won't have to wait long. You can sign up now.
I think we,
for the so we can sign up for access.
Is where you go for the closed alpha PC test available on July 2nd. Blood Hunt will be released later this year.
Oh, that's soon.
July 2nd.
Next, the latest horror game series from the creators of Until Dawn continues with the House
yesterday.
Of Ashes, part of the Dark Pictures anthology. This third game features American and Iraqi soldiers.
Has anyone caught up and like played
temple.
Every single one of these?
Here's the story trailer. Yeah.
Yes.
Do you guys have? Are they good? The like they seem to be pumping these out.
In the depths.
They're entertaining. Like they're not as good as Until Dawn, but they're worth playing.
They're definitely like, fun with chat.
Okay.
Yeah. Like you play like with chat, have like making fun of shit along the way. It's very fun.
An ancient horror has
awoken from
its slumber.
Show's got really good pace to it.
And is hungry for blood. Shall we see how many have fallen into shadow?
Satellite sweeps of the war zone have uncovered what appears to be an underground storage facility. But I strongly suspect where chemical weapons are hidden, so we need to move fast.
Ready to go, guard.
Sorry, what is this?
The Until Dawn brave. Continuation thing. Whatever that series is called.
We're gonna sigh off this shit.
Brothers in arms, or will it be a case of each man for himself?
Get down! They're up on the ridge! Return fire!
Dark Pictures Anthology.
On
the edge of an abyss.
Yep.
Your survival depends on the choices you make. They will be as a compass, guiding you through the unknown.
We're on God's green earth have we landed.
What nightmare have these luckless souls fallen into?
You keep lookout.
Lookout? Lookout for what?
One by one, their lights will be snuffed out. Unless you can find the means to save them. Trapped beneath the earth. Swallowed by the void. Will you find the path to salvation? Or be lost in the darkness? Forever.
The House of Asses.
That's the adult right version. Itself.
I believe you misread that.
I'll what? Spoil the monster.
Oh, the Pazuzu oh, edition. Ah, Black that's position. My favorite edition of a game. The Pazuzu edition.
One of the longest, most beloved JRPG franchises in the industry.
Hey, Tales of Arise.
Tales of series.
I'm very excited.
Well, the latest
for this.
Game, Arise, was announced 2 years ago.
I hope we get to see actual gameplay.
Into
more of it.
3D
they've shown
with
a little
Unreal
bit.
Engine 4. Here's a world premiere look at the latest trailer with more information following in the coming weeks.
Nice.
World premiere.
It's time for some JRPG-ness.
Nice.
He said genus.
Pretty fancy place they got here.
Harmony and coexistence between the Renans and the Danans.
I'm Dohilim Ilkaris.
Oh,
should you need
style
my skills
very
on the battlefield,
good.
Dude, the
all
graphics
care for
look
is
so
maintaining
good.
Peace.
I'm Captain Kisara of the Elden Menency.
I love the armor too.
From now on, when I fight,
I guess she's a party
I fight to protect my dream.
Well, this crew just gets bigger and bigger.
I hate that guy already.
His voice is just great.
That's gonna be the guy that I hate all game long.
So this is like an action RPG?
It's a Tales of game. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, real-time combat.
Been looking for you.
Oh, he looks fucking cool.
Olaf, get the hell out of my realm. This is Tannin's realm, and it's ours, understand?
Don't forget me!
Is it over?
It's only just begun.
That looks cool.
That guy's name is Beferoth.
I hope so.
September 10th.
Yep. Le Petit Prince is apparently the name of this.
The Little Prince! This is such a great story. Is it, if it's the same thing?
Are you being sarcastic?
No. The Little Prince is like, it's like a children's book.
Oh, okay.
And it's,
Zeke's
it's
voice like, went up like really, really good.
No, that, I yeah, I was surprised to hear that. That's why I was asking.
Nintendo Switch on June 29th. And the Little Prince season would start
oh, it's
soon
from the,
after July 6th.
Flower People, which is their lesser known
enjoy
title.
Enjoy the game.
Trying to think of their Journey. This is from the Journey people.
Dude.
Mm-hmm.
Eichmann just announced that he's going to be working with Amazon Games
in
an early preview event for Lost Ark.
Like this show
nice.
Introduce you to new
hell yeah, dude.
That's awesome.
Games that deserve the spotlight.
That's awesome.
You say when?
Definitely the case with this next
no,
title.
No, no, no.
From
more
a
details
small
coming soon.
Swedish studio named Wishfully. Planet of Lana tells the story of a young girl and her loyal friend who embark on a mission through a colorful world that's designed to feel like a gouache watercolor painting come to life. Here's your first look at the Planet of Lana coming to
also,
Xbox
Dat
and
Mods
PC
is gonna
in
be part of that as well, according to chat.
Cool. Oh yeah, man.
Dat Mods played a lot of that that game. Sorry. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Well, that's adorable. Probably gonna die.
I was gonna bet you some subs that it was about to die. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, now I'm attached. They better not kill it.
Well, there's meteors coming to, so they're all dead.
Oh no!
Everyone dies.
I swear to God, if one of those lands on it,
they're all dead.
Someone beat Outriders.
A 90s song cover, real slowed down though. Here we go.
It's actually looking kind of cool. What are those? Reapers, yes, they're probably Reapers.
Wow, hand painted, okay.
Like a platformer.
Whoa.
It is very, very, very pretty. Looks a little Ori in that, at least.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
Planet of Lana?
Is this a Futurama game?
Eh. Planet of Lana!
Danger Zone.
Huh. That looks kind of cool, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, that looks cool.
All right. I want to see more of that one.
Same.
Someone in my chat said, I can't wait for Zeke to play this after Dan plays it.
Wow. Wow.
Wow.
And by someone, I mean Scott, my mod, because...
What a beautiful...
Your main man!
With mods like these, right?
Well, joining me now is Aaron. Oh, God. Who's prepare. The director of Overwatch 2. Overwatch 2. Aaron, great to have you here on Kickoff Live. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much for having us here.
The guy's wearing two short sleeve shirts.
What's planned for Overwatch 2? Just you guys recently you had a PvP live stream that I watched, mm-hmm. and you revealed some changes coming to Overwatch 2. What can you tell us? What's the latest?
Yeah, so we recently announced that Overwatch 2's format is changing to a 5v5
lead guy left the company,
team format.
And
this requires a fresh look at all of our heroes in the game.
Fantastic. It should feel fine. New, we're fine.
Yeah. Familiar to fans of our strategic.
They just told me to come out
combat.
Here. I don't really know anything.
Yeah, it was great to see you guys playing, and you know, I long awaited for people to get a chance to go hands on with it. And today, I know you brought us a look at some skins for some of the characters, right?
Yeah, the team is so passionate about updating
the look and feel
of the world of Overwatch. And one aspect of that is creating entirely new models for Overwatch 2 for all of our heroes. So today we're going to be looking at two of those, Baptiste and Sombra.
That's what the players are screaming for right now.
Tell us a little about what we're seeing.
Show us the skin.
Are they like literally
Overwatch 2? So yeah, what about here?
Yeah, so
they have to be just clueless.
And there's a lot of new technology that goes into our models. We have new hair hater tech, excuse me. A glowing cape and gloves that kind of give that medic or surgeon vibe to him.
Guys, we need more money to finish Overwatch 2, please.
Thank you.
And we're going to Sombra, I think, right?
Yep, so next up is Sombra. This was a very challenging look for us to update. It's an asymmetrical design. There's so many layers of hair and clothing and technology in this. If you look closely, you can actually see circuitry and nodes embedded in her clothing. She's a world-class hacker, so it all makes sense.
No, I get it.
Fortunately, Geoff was the one that knew anything, so they just got to talk about the skins.
The first game updated for Overwatch 2, and we can't wait to see more on the game. We appreciate you giving us a little sneak preview here, and I'm sure there'll be more later this year on Overwatch 2.
You bet. Thank you.
Awesome.
I was dying inside.
Thanks so much,
Aaron. I don't even play the game, and I know that's not what those people want. It's just unfortunate. They announced yesterday that it's got crossplay.
Coming
to it.
But this game is a ton of fun, and it's
coming. It only works in casual, so you can't play ranked with crossplay.
Take a look.
They didn't even mention that.
Oh, this
here.
Actually looks pretty cool.
Hey guys, it's Geoff.
I hope this game is good.
I watched a very long trailer for this today, and it looks very good. They also had half of the Flying Concords doing the audio for it. It was hilarious.
And we've got Geoff, one of the game developers from 2K. Geoff,
if you have 5 minutes, I highly recommend watching the trailer.
And Vermoon.
Okay.
I'll definitely be playing this. Looks fun.
Yep.
That looks like a trap.
Oh my god. Traps.
Ow. Oh, shit.
Oh, I know you can die. I know.
A warrior's death, I died again.
I'm coming to get you.
Oh, wow.
Watch it.
Oh.
Are we going to do a drop frames version of this?
I think I'm doing a sponsored stream for it. I'm too.
Are you doing any sponsored Dark Alliance stuff?
To the point where my wrestling I haven't been contacted about it yet. Is actually based on this character.
I think it's on the
if it's going to happen. But has purple. I just love everything about him.
Like that. We'll talk after
the entire time.
This month?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll be out of town.
Okay. That doesn't look healthy at all. Why'd I just run up on him?
Oh, that's right. I forgot you were here.
You ain't got nothing on us, baby.
Yep. I'm here now.
Oh, whoa. I spoke way too soon.
We got him. We got him. He's gone. He's gone.
Come on.
We don't want any dessert.
There you go.
Let's go.
Damn. What a death. I'm gonna have some weird dreams tonight.
So I noticed the full inventory. This is gonna be the kind of game. Okay.
Yes, it has. So the trailer today is doing a better job of this than this. There's full-on loot, like green, epic, and legendary loot. There's, I think, five or six different classes. Lots of bosses, lots of mobs. Lots of
Paladins?
Looks very good. Is that what this is?
Wait.
Dan's out. He's gone. I thought Paladins.
Oh, that
got
was Battleborn.
Oh, no,
they shut down Battleborn. Yes. Okay. I totally thought they shut this game down. Okay. Okay.
What is Genlock?
All right, Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live presented by Prime Gaming continues. Yesterday
it's
was
a Rooster
an amazing
Teeth show.
Tease of the next Battlefield from EA.
Oh.
If you want to dust up on the history of the franchise, its last big modern-day game,
this is good show, the trailer.
That was Battlefield 4. It's this month. Prime Gaming members get to download it and play it for free through June 20th.
For people wondering,
I had more time, I would totally download and play Battlefield 4.
I did it last week or the week prior. There's still a shit ton of people playing, if you're at all curious, chat.
Free!
Yeah.
It's free, so I mean, tons of people are playing right now.
But even before that, there were still super amounts of people playing it.
Gameplay footage.
It's the last modern day Battlefield.
It's great.
It's going to be really cool. Right now,
also
let's take
be
a
aware,
look at another world
there
premiere.
Were a lot of racists in all the
Monster Hunter Stories is coming to the Switch in July, and we've got your first look at the story.
It might have been that I joined a hashtag support Trump server. I don't know if there's any relationship, but that's what I did.
Any relationship to people like running around with guns?
No.
All crazy, killing people like.
Wings of
what is this?
This is Monster Hunter Rise 2. Or not Rise, Stories. Yeah, Stories. Yeah.
Okay, I was going to say, they went a very different direction.
No, sorry, I missed
that. Okay.
Yeah, by the way, this is not a political stream, guys, all right? We're going to, you know, it's just, we're providing context for battle. Is that what, I think that's what they said for Battlefield.
We can't
Battlefield,
let you
so
interfere with our
us.
Plans.
That's the monster Red Song.
Has anyone played Monster Hunter Stories 1?
You suppose he saw this coming?
I think it's on 3DS, so I'd never got a chance to.
I had a lot of people in chat say it's very good. But I've never played it.
Wow. So of all the timing, apparently CD Projekt Red just came out saying that the data breach that they had earlier this year is apparently much worse than they thought.
So you're going to
Did you see
born,
the EA breach they had this morning? Did you see that one?
No.
Yeah, the Frostbite source code and the FIFA source code got leaked from EA, but there was no player data leaked of any type. But it was confirmed by EA that they have leaked the Frostcode or Frostbite and FIFA 21 source.
Does that mean Battlefield isn't Battlefield Frostbite?
Next, this
I think so.
Legendary rock band hits the road this summer on the Hella Mega Tour with Green Day and Fall Out Boy.
Probably.
But first, they came together with an indie developer to create stream-safe music for the community. Yes, you can co-stream this performance. So turn it up, premiering their brand new never-before-released song.
Turn it
up. Tell me what you
want. Wait, he didn't say that for the last
one. Break. This is Weezer!
Now watch him be wrong and everyone get DMCA'd.
I know, right?
Because of a technicality.
Geoff kills Twitch. Sponsored by YouTube.
It'd be really weird if that happened with him sponsored by Amazon.
Oh, he grew his hair. I haven't seen him in a very long time.
Dude, he still looks like he's in college. How does he do that?
He's a vampire. Don't be influenced by an office full of dorks. Whoa. I won't mention any names.
Pitchfork. What? Tell me what you want. I think it has to do with the game.
Maybe they did the soundtrack for this game and that's why they can stream this.
Sounds like Weezer. What is the name of this game that they're tastemaker to tell promoting? Me which way
to go. I don't know if they said.
So I can play the halftime Ridge show Racer. Okay, thanks, Jeff. This is the new Ridge Racer. Everyone's entitled to their own opinions. Here's a big chance, yeah, you got the next 3 seconds. Tell me what you want. I'm gonna get right on it. Tell me what you want. Yeah, I'm kind of with you, Coz. I don't know if we need music performances. You know?
Yeah.
I don't think we need it at all, to be honest.
Yeah.
Movie trailers, music performances. I'd much rather keep gaming shows about gaming.
Yeah.
I don't mind the movie stuff so much, but...
Nope. No movies. Nope. Yeah, nope.
This one's just... I just...
This feels like filler.
Yeah. Yeah, this feels like, hey, we gotta stretch.
Jeff needs to get a coffee break or something.
Yeah. Which I get, right? Like, you need to have production breaks and stuff, and I understand that, but...
What if it was Mick Gordon? Okay, it's different if it's Mick Gordon. That's different.
It's different if I like it.
If I like it, that's a completely separate thing.
Yeah.
That's a different ballgame.
Completely separate. Dude, Mick Gordon comes out and it's just him sitting in the middle of the freaking stage. He's shredding the guitar part to like a Doom thing. Like, okay. We can do that.
Yeah.
We can do that. That's okay.
What about Soken singing Lahi on a Amatone? I don't know what the fuck it's called. What are those called?
Oh, the woo-woo things? No, I don't think we're talking about the same thing.
That was so amazing.
I forget.
Thank you, Rivers and Guys, for that. Both the song and the game released tomorrow on PC, Nintendo Switch.
You should watch that video.
Music streaming platforms.
You want to see what's going on in Final Fantasy.
And a limited edition 7-inch vinyl on iMovie.
Wait, I don't mind these performances when they're video game related.
Right now, let's turn to a game that we announced.
I don't like it when it's just some random song I don't know about because I'm old. From
Amplitude. Dan, what was the bet to get you to play Final Fantasy? What was I?
Fans wanted more. Well, here's an
if they announce it at all, or show Elden Ring at all, I'll play Final Fantasy.
Oh, okay. All right, so we sweetened the deal. Okay.
We're stuck in this wreck until everybody learns the rules. Yep, all of them. Rule number one, certain weapons work better on certain monsters. Learn it or die. Oh, option B then. Rule number two, use turrets to protect that unstable dust bomb we call the crystal. Because it's their catnip.
And what is this? This was cool.
Endless dungeon. Yeah.
Yep.
I totally thought this was something like else. That.
Rule number three, watch your slot.
Speaking of dungeons, like I made a list of like E3 like and the crystal, not going to happen, but a guy can dream. Like I made
you
a list.
Alone,
yeah.
You die alone.
And I just want to. I want to see more Darkest Dungeon 2 stuff.
We haven't heard anything about that in a while.
Somewheres. I saw a leaked picture of some stuff. They like character portraits and stuff like that, and they like elongated them.
Is
made a more human look or human like size rather than like a squished like caricature.
Is Darkest Dungeon Devolver?
No,
it's not. Okay,
I don't believe so.
I think like PC Gamer. Oh, had that
is no, it's Red Hook is the developers, but I don't know who the publishers are.
That's a remake of the 16-bit one. What are you guys doing tonight?
If you're lucky enough to have a PS5, you're probably getting ready to play Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. I've been playing it and having a ton of fun. Well, later today, the team at Insomniac is going to be doing a special launch stream on Twitch.
Thank you.
Tell us more. Take it away, Marcus and Mike.
Oh, shit, I scored a draw.
Hey, Jeff, and everybody watching Summer Games Fest Kickoff Live.
Dan, Ratchet and Clank, very good.
Oh, my God.
I'm very excited to see it.
It is so good.
Yeah, I'm going to play this game.
I wasn't going to. Good the gameplay and the graphics are. It's just so good.
2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern.
How is it for just fun factor? Enjoy the whole time?
It's great. Yeah, it's got humor. It's got
Unlike daily,
everything you'd want in a Ratchet and Clank game, it has it and more.
In addition to playing through the opening of the game, we'll also be taking your questions.
I want to applaud you, Dan, for getting through that without saying Pixar. Good job.
Uh-huh.
So please join us at twitch.tv/insomniacgames at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern.
Oh my god, I just got the Keighley face.
Oh damn, I did too.
We'll see you there.
A wave must have just gone out.
Oh, is it spamming chat when everyone gets one?
All right, we're now about to join.
No, it's optional. You can do it yourself if you want. And I did because I'm a dick.
I totally did too.
Six. Giancarlo, thank you for joining us. So why did you want to take
on? Remember, guys, no politics in this game.
They came to me with this phenomenal idea.
No, no, there's politics. They've now come out and said there's politics.
No, they came out again and reversed that. So now it's back to no politics.
Okay. Yara with this big vision and dream for his country, and it really appealed to me because he was
a great actor. I love him.
I like his house, and then there's just a Peloton.
And a love of his community and country,
yeah.
And it was so in,
you had to make
in
it
line
fit, you know?
With
it's
what's going on in the world politically today, and what has happened in the past. I thought, what a great opportunity. The other part of it is it's just a different technology that's so brand new, and it excites me as a filmmaker that I wanted to
it's
be
weird
a part
they have
of
little Yubi.
All right, well, you've
sticker.
Played some absolutely amazing villains in your career. What was it like being a video game villain?
No, I'm not a villain. I got to push back on you. I'll let you finish. But this guy loves his country. He wants to empower you, Keighley. He wants to empower you to stand up and speak your truth.
Uh-oh.
Now, you can Keighley's go back like, to calling me a villain if you like.
Stop it.
Well, you are smiling on the box. You're a good guy, right?
Oh. Complexity.
I am because I feel like we as human beings fall in line, and I want to be a renegade within reason. How do you like that? Because I think part and parcel of us falling in line and doing what we need to do and thinking about the cumulative effect of our doing what's right and the
I'm not a villain shows
is
torture
also
scene
to stand up and say he
paid me to do that.
They're good and bad about all people, but this guy
teaching his son
his
to torture
passion for his people, even if they're faceless to him at certain points in time, allow him to be an absolute hero.
Speaking of your character, who did you base him on or study to create this character?
It's so interesting because, of course, the obvious choice to study is Fidel Castro, and it is Cuba, an island that had so many resources, but really
Ubisoft
the dream of the ability of the
people
to cultivate those resources, something got in the way there.
He meant Fidel Castro.
No relation. Fidel, that's his brother. He's great. Nice guy.
I was just talking
Runs
to
a great
one of my
country.
Daughters about Ceausescu and also Hitler. We were talking about zodiac signs and what signs were certain people. What is that mindset that has you wanting to
name
be,
drop, bud?
Have power
job.
Over
there you go.
My God.
And for each dictator,
didn't expect
to
hit their name
Ceausescu
drop in this. That would have been a nice bingo card.
So anyway,
holy shit!
All right, well, one last question for you: who would win in a square off between Gus Fring, Moff Gideon, and Anton?
You know, and I have my favorites.
You know,
of those
you literally
two,
see the Ubisoft lawyer just like
question.
The fan.
Yeah.
And you know,
holy shit.
Immediately I say Moff Gideon. Immediately. You know, somehow I think Gus is colder and displays that coldness in a very
Who had Hitler
way.
On their Game Award or their Summer Games Fest
know,
bingo
I
card?
Think Anton
for real, man.
Would be the most violent
Jesus.
Man on earth. But given his situation,
no, I got a bingo, man. I got Hitler, 9/11, COVID.
Moff Gideon.
I got four of them from Kojima.
This guy thinks in a different way.
I still can't believe that Kojima
and
thing. That was hilarious.
He does like, all his own dirty work, and he has an incredible.
From Tiny Tina to
out.
Talking
so
about
I'm
COVID.
Say Moff Gideon.
I love it. Right.
Fair enough. All right, Giancarlo, thank you so much for
it went from
out.
Not this isn't political to let's just lean the hell in.
Six.
Like let's go
and
all
I can't
political.
Wait for it to begin. Let the games begin.
Awesome. All right.
He seems like he'd be fun to hang out with.
You haven't picked up on it yet.
He seems like a fun guy.
Prime Gaming unlocks a ton of in-game benefits for Amazon Prime members, like an exclusive Valkyrie skin in Apex Legends.
I
want to
believe that he's like, like, have you ever seen like outtakes from any other Billy Bob Thornton movies? He always like, there's always outtakes of him doing like the Sling Blade guy. Now, because he still does that. I wonder if he still does like a spring for like certain things, like at like on different movies or parties or something.
Probably. You would think so. Oh, it's Nier. And Fall Guys.
Oh my god. So...
That's actually like
oh my god. Amazing.
That's actually incredible.
I that
Do they
is
call
my
her
skin.
Two Bean?
I hope so.
That's oh my god.
That's
dude.
Really great.
That is great.
The best follow, the best crossover right there.
The old Genshin Impact. Their new
Gamba! Gamba, 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 Gamba.
They are updating this game very frequently. It's actually kind of crazy.
It's making them a bajillion dollars.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they have all the reason to. It's just, you look at this and you compare it to like what other live service games are doing. Like, they're pushing out the content.
Hidden talents. Mm-hmm. And hopefully this time, getting a vision to glow again. Your opponent is new to the Clash, but he has quickly become the dark horse of the tournament. The vision is missing.
The sounds of nature turn into a clamor of noise during stormy weather. The winds are coming.
Clubs I will high. Say, like, this oh! game... had like a surprising amount of complexity when I was I had a tough fight.
So today we've announced yeah. games,
it reminded me a little bit of Final Fantasy 14 so in that like the cycles of stuff. Too.
And joining sure. me now are Dave Anthony and Jason Blundell from the newly formed Deviation Games. We know you guys well from all
about
your amazing work 20, over the years with Treyarch and Call of Duty Black Ops. But
those eyes bother
what
me.
What can we expect from your new studio, guys?
Well, thanks, Geoff. And look, Jason and I, we've been mates for donkey's years. And well, like an old married
couple, I'm stealing that phrase.
And we've been working together for decades.
Donkey's years.
And we've worked on some huge franchises. You know the games. You know, they've done well. And but we thought, you know, when you're working on those franchises, the long established IPs, you're working within very, very tight constraints creatively about what you can do. So we thought, after all these years, you know, what if we deviated?
Yes.
So that's Deviation Games.
Okay.
So Geoff, just trust me, all bets are off. From
right.
day one, we got complete financial security.
Yeah.
This guy's so nervous, I think.
Yeah, his hands are very shaky.
Not just to make a brand new
yeah.
IP, which
yeah.
is what we're doing.
Kind of endearing, though.
A groundbreaking new IP with
maybe
innovation
he saw
at its
very
core.
For,
and the team at
from software
Deviation
game.
Games, the culture we have is
still
really,
shaking.
Really
maybe.
Simple.
Maybe. It's he probably also
no
heard Gus say
ego.
Hitler, and he's like, fuck.
It's the best idea that always wins.
How
do
we follow
that? All right, well, big ideas from you guys, as we would expect. Now, I know it's very early, and there is nothing to show on the game today, but can you tell us a bit about what kind of game you're
oh.
making? What can we expect?
Yeah, I mean, you're very right there, Geoff. Very early, but a lot of exciting stuff going on. So essentially, we spent the last year building the team, right? And so
how do you get on a show like this when you have, like, nothing? Like, it's just an announcement
creative,
of a studio.
Collaborative people and bring
this
them
is like
together
a Kickstarter.
Kind of under one roof, and that's
what
Deviation
is. Money,
money,
money.
Yeah, we don't have anything to show right now, but that collaboration, that imagination
yeah, I wonder who,
is going on, and we're going to have something that's
who
gonna,
invested them on
I think
day one.
An indelible mark in the industry when we come out.
All right. Well, with you guys involved, as I said, we're excited about it. There is one more piece of the puzzle, though, that you want to reveal today.
These other people have
that,
games, but we got
this.
The ideas, man.
Oh. Hey.
People.
Oh, PlayStation got him here.
Hmm. Okay. That
okay,
makes sense.
Big news. The stage has changed. Blue of PlayStation, so you're partnering with PlayStation. What can you tell us about that partnership?
That's right, Geoff. And the partnership with PlayStation, it's all about quality. From soup to nuts, this project is all about quality.
I love these.
And our team
British
is deviating
to
have
nuts.
These are great.
Back
that mean?
In the studio. We're doing this for you. We are so proud of you. And the partnership with Sony, it's very, very simple. I mean, God, just look at the track record of consistency, of high-quality games that they do. It's hit after hit. It's award after award. And now we've been part of this process and we see how they do things. Yeah. It's really clear
1800s,
how they're managing to accomplish that. So we couldn't be more proud.
When a meal typically started with soup and ended with,
which we're going to do in a very,
with
very
nuts, with a pork served with nuts.
Yeah, let's just face it, right? Sony rocks.
So it just means from beginning to end.
Brand of crazy, so we're That's very right. happy with this partnership.
All right, so Deviation Games, PlayStation, brand new IP, a mega IP, it sounds like, coming in the future. And hopefully we'll see you guys again in the future to see more on what you're working on.
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
Awesome. All right. Dave, Jason, thank you very much, guys. All right. Well, this year is the 30th anniversary of Sonic the Hedgehog, and later this month, we are honored to be premiering the
That was a lot of real estate for
But right now, here's the Philharmonic Orchestra in Prague performing the music of Sonic Unleashed.
Now we're talking.
Are we, though?
I have no nostalgia or anything for Sonic, so no, not... Was anyone here at Dan, were you a Sega kid or no?
I got to play my cousin's Sega for a little bit sometimes.
Yeah.
Not really.
That's the same.
We were a Nintendo household.
Yeah, same.
Until PS2.
Yep. That's exactly the same as us. PS1, I think.
My parents were like, you're getting one console, we're getting you a Nintendo, and that's it.
There was a rumor going around today that Xbox is going to announce 3 more studio acquisitions on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Sega was potentially one of those, which would be kind of crazy.
Yeah, I could see that.
I think the actual Japanese government is pretty strict on companies outside of Japan buying Japanese companies or some shit, so a lot of people are saying it's not going to happen, but... We'll see. Yeah, Microsoft will just buy Japan instead. That's correct.
Yeah. we'll get around this loophole.
There was a lot of... Microsoft made a lot of announcements this morning. They said... every quarter, every 3 months, a brand new first-party game will be coming to Game Pass for the next, I don't know how many years it was, but...
Love orchestra music. All right,
Warner
Brothers Games and Turtle Rock will be giving players a new look at the zombie multiplayer fun of Back 4 Blood. And right now, we've got a quick tease of a new boss and news on the beta coming later. This summer.
Anyone play the alpha or whatever that this had out?
I did.
It was I've heard
very, very fun.
Okay.
If you like Left 4 Dead, it hit all those notes perfectly.
Cool.
And even more so.
Awesome.
PvP. Ooh.
One of the things I'm most passionate about is getting you guys access to play more games at home. Last year, Steam and Xbox did incredible demo events around Summer Game Fest, and this year, Steam's Next Fest starts next Wednesday, and Xbox is back again to do an ID at Xbox demo event, which I'm announcing right now. It starts on Tuesday and is completely free, no badges required. Cool. One of the games I'm most excited about in the lineup is Tunic.
Next week.
From my fellow Canadian,
as well,
Andrew Scholdice. Here he
17th,
is to give you a little sneak preview
or is this
of the brand
of?
New demo,
I'm not
which
sure.
you can exclusively play on Xbox starting on Tuesday.
I think it's like 17th to 24th off the top of my head. I hope that's right.
Hi, my name's Andrew Schuldeis, and I'm working on Tunic, which is an isometric action adventure about a tiny fox in a big world where you explore the wilderness, fight monsters, and find
secrets. We heard about this game.
First started working on it about 6 years ago.
And our style's super cute.
And it's been Rami speaks very highly of this game. Over the years, but I'm really excited about where we've gotten it to today. So in Tunic, you start the game, and you are a little fox that's washed up on a beach, and you don't have a whole lot of context except for, you know, a lust for adventure, and you are going to wander off, and maybe you're going to find a stick. And
Geoff Keighley just tweeted, "It's almost time."
Find a sword.
Really?
It's really about that sense of discovery.
Being such a tease.
Wondering what's around.
I don't think he would.
People have
the amount of shit he would get if he was doing that, and it didn't lead to anything.
New demo that was
would be immeasurable.
It's going to lead to something. It's just
never.
Will it be what we're thinking?
A brand new dungeon, a bunch of
maybe more Overwatch skins.
Maybe more Kojima director's cut of Death Stranding.
So excited about Tunic, and Sable also is going to be one of the games in that, along with a lot of other awesome titles. So check that out next week on Xbox. Next up, stave off Ragnarok in this ancient Norse-inspired co-op action survival RPG that you can also fully play solo. Classic hack and slash gameplay goes Viking in Norsefell's Tribes of Midgard, launching on PlayStation and PC July 27th. Here is the brand new trailer.
That was he's a professional. That was a mouthful right there.
I know.
Without any mess up.
I would have stumbled all over that.
There was no hiccups either. That was a great read.
I think this one looks pretty cool. Clothes that aren't as drafty. This is Valheim.
Your journey starts in the wilderness. Yeah. Hunt down action pets, RPG style.
Gather rare resources and explore the untamed world.
This actually looks very similar to the starting area. And use those resources to forge Viking worthy gear.
You must protect the seed of this is like ARPG Valheim.
Oh, this world and everything in it will be destroyed forever. So take heed. The Helthings rise when the sun sets. Destroy these dark spirits before they destroy the seed. Each victorious night makes way for a new day. To venture into new lands, build to greater heights, and face fiercer creatures. And with great risk comes great rewards. But be careful. You're of little use to Midgard, squashed by a troll.
Kind of reminds me of what the original Fortnite was, where you go out in the day, gather resources, come back at night, build up a base.
Yeah. Of your tribe, wow, that's a lot of people. Giants are on their way. Whoa.
That's cool.
And it's time for us to
this is multiplayer, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's show them our might.
Dang.
Is greater than
that's
their
cool.
Height.
That might be really fun.
Yeah, this could really work. Goes, great collab game.
Valhalla. Can't wait.
Huh.
Yeah, looks cool. Looks fun.
Now, I don't know what I want, but like,
who's ready for
so many
some
like Vikings
dead.
And medieval like
game last December
shit.
At TGA, and now it's time
there's a
for
lot.
An extended look.
I just want a taste
at
of something else,
play.
You know.
To tell us more, let's turn it over to my
like
friend.
Vikings are the
Tim
new
Willett
zombies. Everyone's doing a Viking game now.
Yeah, yeah. True.
It's great to see.
You can thank God of War for that.
Today we have some extended footage of The Evil Dead the game. We are excited to show you this. And to help me explain it is Bruce Campbell. Thank you.
Ace.
Wait, did he have an Iron Man statue? Then we'll play the footage back after later, chat. Take a look at it. Wait, who the fuck is that guy?
Well, that's Bruce Campbell.
No, the guy running around right now. Why is there like a knight?
I'm Bruce Campbell. You know me as Ash Williams, the dude who saved the world.
Oh, time travel and shit was Army
Darkness
stuff.
I'm
going to bring
you the lowdown on the upcoming Evil Dead the game.
Henry the Red.
You and your friends will team up as
classic
Evil Dead
heroes
pretty
good.
To live the nightmare.
Yeah.
You'll use savage finishing moves or tear evil a new one.
He's the king from Army of Darkness.
Into the
it's been a while.
The world thing. We have another option.
It's very Friday the 13th.
You can play as the vile Kandarian demon itself. But who would want to do that? He'd be a dick. With the power of possession in your arsenal, you'll scare those goody two-shoes to death. Literally, you can do that if you're a dick. Whether you choose the path of evil or righteousness, you'll be throwing down in places you've seen before. You'll collect pages of the Necronomicon, uncover Nobi's lost tapes, and track down other legendary artifacts. When you've grabbed enough, you'll use a spell to send the Kandarian son of a bitch back to the hellhole it came from.
So this is like it's like a Dead by Daylight Friday the 13th kind of game.
Yeah, it's kind of mixing the two together.
It was no accident that Ash always wore brown pants.
Nice.
Oh.
That's my aim. Can't hit the head.
Dude, a nice little outline around the head there.
Yeah. All warning shots.
Resident Evil 4 was all
misses.
It was just dick shot after dick shot. Like, it was insane. Like, I killed so many people by shooting them in the crotch. It was.
I'll spoil those good looks.
Damn.
Okay, that was cool.
Yeah, that was intense.
Hey.
Okay, guys.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Now it's time for the grand finale to the show. This is extremely special. Today, I am so deeply honored to be given the opportunity to share this next game. It comes from one of our industry's most acclaimed developers and a previous Game of the Year winner at the Game Awards. I want to personally thank this developer for believing in my vision of Summer Game Fest as a new way to bring all of us together for a cross-industry showcase and kick off the summer in the right way. So,
man, this is
without
this is
up.
Oh, this is
sit
he's
back
from
and
mobile.
Enjoy this truly spectacular world premiere.
Anthem
it
card game
is finally time.
If he's debating, then this is gonna be hilarious.
World premiere.
Nope, this is it.
Oh, it's it. Yes,
that is it.
No gameplay. No gameplay.
I should have had a conversation of what gameplay means.
Yeah,
but let's keep watching.
Gameplay is what you would play, not in-game engine. It is the view of somebody playing the game.
Sure.
Gameplay.
We'll soon return.
Oh my god.
Guided by grace.
There's the open worldness of it.
The Golden Order is broken to its core.
There's the mounted combat stuff.
Now this, I mean, this doesn't have anything to do with the like Souls mythos, right? It's its own thing.
We don't know. Who knows?
We don't know. Nobody knows. Okay.
Yeah.
Probably not. But.
In search of the Elden Ring, emboldened by the flame of ambition.
It's kind of Bloodborne-y with some of that stuff.
It totally looks Bloodborne-y.
Yeah.
Makes sense, of course. That's gameplay. That's gameplay. That's gameplay.
And they will die.
God, it's not much, though.
Dude, look at that mounted combo. Oh my god, look at that sword.
Wow. Like they've taken everything they've learned from all their previous games.
Oh, there's the co-op.
Even Blue Spirits.
Oh my god, look at that fucking dragon.
Damn.
He's got a thunderbolt.
Be born.
Oh.
Well. A lowly tarnished.
Do we get a release date?
Playing as a lord.
I'll freak out if we do.
I think release year 2022 or early 2022.
Yeah. Available right now.
Shit, this looks so good.
This looks so good.
Stunning.
Oh, there's caster stuff.
That looked like a serious spell, too.
Yeah. Whoa.
Wow, that looked badass.
Brandish the Elden Ring.
Oh, I cannot wait.
For all of us.
My God. Oh my God, there we go, date.
Oh, January 21st.
Holy Woo! Shit.
Woo!
All right.
Oh my
All
God,
right.
It actually happened.
Man.
Oh my Elden God. Elden Ring is coming, as you saw, January 21st, 2022 to
oh
next
my
gen,
God.
Current gen. It's so incredible, and I want to thank so much
so it's cross-gen.
Miyazaki-san and the team at From for sharing that in-game look at Elden Ring.
Did it have a PC or Steam
oh
tag
God.
There
I'm
at the
free,
end or no?
Out of prison, all right. And that's going to do it for Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live. Thank you so much to all the developers who took part. And for you and watching around the world,
PC.
It means so much to me. Summer Game
oh,
Fest
really?
Continues all weekend with
okay.
Netflix Geeked Week and Prime Matter tomorrow, Ubisoft Forward on Saturday,
oh,
and Xbox
shit.
And Bethesda on Sunday, Square Enix as well. Head to summergamefest.com for the full and complete schedule. And this is really just the kickoff to summer and a ton of other amazing events that I'm fully supportive of, and I'm very excited to see what they have in store for us as well. As for me, I'll see you again on August 25th.
Did it mention George R. R. Martin anywhere
Live.
In there?
And this December, I am so happy to say
no.
that the Game Awards will return as an in-person ceremony at the Microsoft Theater in Los
estimate.
Angeles. More details are coming later this
oh,
summer.
Chat thing at the beginning
Thanks again for being
oh,
a part of Summer Game Fest. We will see you tomorrow for
Holy
more. And stay
fuck.
Tuned for the Day of the Devs with I Am 8-Bit and Double Fine right now. Good night, everybody.
That was great.
That's
pretty good.
That was a great trailer.
Oh.
Wild to think that Keighley is at the point where, like, is the show where they announce
totally
that, you know
yeah.
where they show that off
yeah.
that's really wild
absolutely
that's really wild
yeah that is I mean if you think about it like Microsoft and or Sony would pay millions to get that on their
millions
on their show mm-hmm. right and it went to Keighley that's wow okay well that's the show. I thought as a show that was really good. I thought the music stuff
yeah.
kind of hit / missed. I thought the first performance was good. The other two were kind of like, this is odd, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
The free guide trailer just was a little odd as well. Also, I hope streamers didn't watch that on stream. That's very risky. But yeah, apart from that, I think regardless of what he showed, like Elden Ring is going to be the thing that everyone's talking about, right? Like that's going to be what everyone loses their shit at from that event. I want to try to find the trailer here real quick on YouTube just to play it back while we talk about it. It looked very good though. It looked like a Souls game through and through without question with some mounted combat in there. Like open worldy too in a, like, how do you feel about it? How do you feel about an open world Dark Souls? If that is to believed, I don't know if we can really say that it was from what we saw there, but it definitely looked like the world was
well,
pretty big.
Dark Souls has always been kind of open world a little bit.
Kind of.
So
yeah.
It's like semi open
yeah.
world. So I would imagine it's going to be similar to what we've seen. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that there's definitely a conversation of this, of if Dark Souls is open world for sure.
What constitutes open world though? Like, what is the qualification? Just meaning
the big thing
about travel anywhere.
The big thing about open world is it means the majority of the world is accessible from the very beginning of the game. So you can basically go anywhere and do anything when you want. Semi-open
right.
world generally means that there's like very large areas that are content locked which is kind of like what Dark Souls is. You have to beat certain boss. You go to
right.
a new area, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's certainly
yeah.
not linear.
Okay.
Like, that's where Dark Souls okay. is this weird kind of in the middle, because it is very much not linear, but at the same time, you do, it's kind of like, it's linear like a spider web. Like, you can go out different directions, but they're all kind of, you know, you have lots of directions to choose from.
That looks...
Right.
I mean, that's
kind of unique.
If this is like, hey, I can go over here, yeah. I can go in here, like, that looks more open than the game has ever been, if that's the case.
Can I go in that castle back there? I want to know. It looks really cool.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So it's what you're saying is the difference between like a semi-open world and open world is there's no boss lock content. Every boss is the end of that particular road.
It's more like large parts of the game are behind those parts. So like a good example is like the most recent Zelda game was a pretty open world. You could kind of go wherever you wanted right at the beginning. Yeah. Skyrim, you can kind of go where you want. There's still parts that you have to access via the main story and things, but the majority of the world, the large majority of the world, you can just go wherever you want. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Fuck, that looks so good.
Dude, I mean, I honestly think this is the best way to go because of its open world style. You can just fucking add content. You can just keep adding shit, adding islands, adding, you know, paths and terrain and all that shit.
Mm-hmm. And to have mounts, you have to have very big areas where most of Dark Souls is very claustrophobic. So it's going to be big open spaces. It'd be interesting to see how that style works in these vast areas where you're mounted and stuff.
You couldn't really do a mount in Bloodborne or any of the Dark Souls, really.
Oh, man. Like, do you realize how fucking much money they could make if there was like cosmetic mount for sale? Like if you could ride a fucking giant spider or, you know, like a Dark Souls dragon or some shit. Oh my God, I'd lose my fucking wallet.
You know, we started with horse armor, and if this is the thing that kills gaming, then we'll end with horse armor. I don't know if we'll ever see From Software have like MTX though. That would be a little.
No. I think it should be like something you can.
Oh, just something you can do.
I would like to see something you can do in game.
Totally.
But if you don't want to like wait for it, you can buy it. Like, what's that? What do they call it in Warframe? It's pay to not wait. What progression what's the term for that?
Pay to progress.
Pay to progress.
Yeah.
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 You didn't have to wait like the 10 hours for your material to be done or your fucking thing to be done.
Sure. Yeah, I don't know. I just want to watch this trailer on repeat. I think the more... it's one of those things where I don't think it's actually... And this sounds so, like, dramatic and stupid, but it's one of those things where I don't actually... I haven't grasped that we're seeing the fucking new Dark Souls game yet. And the more that I watch the trailer, I'm just like, oh, okay. Yeah, this is actually... This is a real game that we will actually play in January of 2022 on the
21st. They've done a good job keeping the lid on it too.
Right? Yeah.
Like that was pretty impressive considering we're 6 months out now. Like,
yeah.
Nice job, man. Yeah. Nice job.
For them to feature the like blue souls in there, I wonder how much of an emphasis they're going to have on co-op. And also if you think about the idea of PvP in an open world game, how much of like, what are going to be the limits of that? Is it just going to be a Red's Phantom has entered your world? Good luck. And it's like the entire world.
You'll run into him in a couple hours.
Yeah. I wonder what that means. I wonder how all the systems work.
How far away the blue ghost can go away from you. Like, can they go across the map and do something? Or do they have to stay near you? It's going to be interesting to see all those little details come out.
Totally. Yeah. Chat saying like PvP zones or an arena. Like if you have a boss arena, maybe you have a PvP arena or something like that. It looks great. I love the fact that the fucking dragon catches a lightning bolt from the sky and then slams it down to the ground.
Sure, why not? Yeah,
like that's,
why not?
That's the most Dark Souls thing that you could think of. It looks very impressive. Yeah, can't wait. I would love to know more at any time they want to start letting us know more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I can't wait to die to all these bosses over and over again.
Many times.
Yeah. Well, like how does death factor into an open world Dark Souls of this style, right? Like, is there a bonfire? I guess
it'll be an altar system.
Yeah. Probably, is there a bonfire, probably. Like a checkpoint nearby or I don't know. I don't know.
Have we or you guys or anything like that, like multiplayer, like, is there anything to that?
In the sense of what we know?
Yeah.
No, this is the first time we've ever seen this game gameplay wise.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. We saw the CG trailer.
It just seems like people are just like, this is the only words that I've heard. So I figured there would be more than just the name of the game and the company who's making it.
No, man.
But apparently this is the first anybody's seen of any of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. There was a leaked
trailer.
I didn't realize
how far it traveled on just the names.
Yep.
Like behind it.
They had a CG Holy trailer fuck. In 2019. And then this is the next time we've seen it, 2 years after the fact. That's how much weight the Miyazaki brand carries, right? To have that much hype going into it. Looks great.
Oh, damn, man.
Love the summon horse there. That looks fucking awesome. That forest looks great. Cross-generational, so it will be on the current systems, the PS4, Xbox One, as well as the PS5 and Xbox Series X, as well as PC. I think it said digital, so Steam and whatnot. I would assume Steam. I think there is a Steam page for it.
Dude, it's only like 7 months away. Holy shit.
Yeah. Yeah. We're close. We're close. I'm waiting for that. Well, I got the subs now that I see that, Dan. Thank you for that. I think also...
You're welcome.
Go to the subs as well.
I did. It's not from me, though, because Twitch is deactivating sub gifting on my account. So it's from...
Hold on. What? What? Did you...
What?
Did you do too many?
I have not been able to gift a sub properly for over 6 months.
Yep. Can you say
it
why?
It errs out every time. No, it just errs out. Like, the Twitch... subgroup has been like troubleshooting it for weeks now. They don't know why, but I can gift perfectly on a new Twitch account, but on my account, nope.
Wow.
So I had to make a completely separate account, co-gift subs, and that's my thing now.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you. Regardless.
Yeah. You're welcome.
By the way, the stream's still going over on the Game Awards. They announced Axiom Verge 2. I don't know if that was already announced, and they're showing some...
Oh! Really? The Metroid-like thing?
Yep. And they're showing some Phantom... Whatever the Devolver game is. Phantom something or other. At the moment. Which is what Lyric...
Oh, the played. Runner.
Yeah, the Runner game. Yeah, the game that Lyric was doing. Phantom Abyss. There you go. Yeah. Fuck. What else was shown? Like, I'm so Elden Ring focused right now, I think, is the rest of the gaming world is right now. Was there, do you guys have any other big takeaways?
Have we talked about Elden Ring yet? They announced that one.
No, Dan, what do you know about Elden Ring? Let's check out this trailer again. We'll
apparently more time. January 21st, they just released a trailer.
That's like 7 months from now. Holy shit. Let's check out the trailer here for the first time.
Definitely want to know more about that vampire game. That's like it could be cool.
Yeah.
Just to be different.
What was
I did 10 tier threes.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you. There you go.
Lost Ark too.
Oh, Lost Ark. Yeah, that looked very. They said you can sign up for the alpha or what? What is the
playlostark.com? You can sign up to get into the alpha and then Blood Hunt. I don't know if it's bloodhunt.com or play bloodhunt, but you can also sign up for the alpha of the other game as well.
And that's the Vampire the Masquerade IP game.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hoping it looks to be like some kind of multiplayer vampire power game, which could be cool. I mean, it could be fun.
I'm going to click away here while I.
It's bloodhunt.com. Cool.
Thank you. Bloodhunt.com. Awesome. Yeah, I'm just going to sign up
for this. I played Lost Ark for around 6 months in the Russian version. I think you're going to like it, says Reeps. Oh, dude, I'm looking forward to it. I am looking forward to it. If the content is there and it's as fun as it looks, like, it could be really cool.
Totally.
Dark Alliance looked good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I will watch the trailer that they put out today for that. If you're at all interested or on the fence about Dark Alliance, it has Jermaine something or other from the Flying Conchords, which used to be an HBO show. He does
Jermaine. Yeah.
Jermaine. Okay. There you go. Yeah.
Yep. I always said Jermaine too, but there's no R in there.
Oh, well, there you go.
Oh, Jermaine.
He does the voiceover for the trailer, and it's very funny, and it's a very well-made trailer in that regard. Shows you everything that's going to be in the game. I think it's like 4.5 minutes, 5 minutes long. So that looks very good. Let me see. There's usually a website off the top of my head. Chat, what's the website that has all of the game trailers on it after the fact?
E3 recap, I think.
Let's see. 2020.e3. I'm not going to say the name, actually. We have too many people watching. You'll crash it. let me see if they are keeping up to date this.
Oh, yeah, it looks like all the trailers are there.
Yeah. Yeah. You got to put in the right. I was on the wrong year. Yeah, we can just, I'll look through this here real quick. Back for Blood. Definitely want to see more of that. I think we're all pretty interested in that. A weird Far Cry 6 thing. They really sent Giancarlo out there, and he did not give a fuck about the idea if that game's political or not. He just went full send, which was kind of funny to see from that. I don't know if that was a response to all of that, or if it just happened, or if he just felt like bringing up Hitler in the middle of an E3 presentation. But one of those things is true, because it all happened. So...
I doubt he like he was hip to the buzz of that shit. It's just like he, you know, he's an actor. He's a solid like actor, so he goes into his method, you know, like or the method of, you know, these characters that he plays and stuff like that. So
yeah.
You know, he's playing probably a power-hungry despot of some sort, and like That shit you think about and talk about with your director and whatnot, if they're any good.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Also, I heard he's super into Hitler. Super, like, just, woo!
Jesus Christ. we saw the...
On his Twitter bio. Like, yes, I played Gus Fring. I'm super into Hitler, by the way.
Hashtag Hitler stan.
Jesus Christ.
Oh no.
Oh my God.
We need to stop. No.
Right, we got to stop, guys. Let's move on.
JP, we were keeping the line blurry.
No, fuck the line.
Solid as a laser.
You got to just push on through to the other side. It. Full bore or nothing. All right.
Okay.
Full bore or nothing. Just like Escape from Tarkov, the Streets of Tarkov, this new map update here. Did they have a time attached to this at all? Is someone who has not played Tarkov, because I am waiting for a wipe of the entire game. I think Ko is in the same boat. I don't know if they attached a date or anything to this, or a month to this. Okay. Late 2021 is as specific as they have gotten. Great. This looks awesome. Except for that APC at the end. What do you know about Tarkov, Dan?
I know it's a... like, you go in and you have to... as much loot as possible, and you want to try to leave, and you have to fight other players and some NPCs, but you want to try to escape with loot if you can, basically.
It's about, that's pretty good expectation of it. It usually doesn't happen. Usually some random shit will happen, and you'll just get slaughtered by a random bullet that ricochets off of a wall or some shit. You never know.
Yeah, you hear a gunshot and it's over. You're like, oh, where did that come from?
Yep, a single gunshot can completely end an entire run that's been going for 50 minutes, which kind of the allure of that game.
Chat loves that kind of stuff.
Yeah. It's as someone who's spent, I think Ko's probably spent more time with it than I have, but in my however many hours I put into it, 30 or 40, it's intense in a way that you kind of want from a game like that, but sometimes it can be a little bit too much. Because you've been in the same area and you keep hearing someone screaming off to the side, but you don't want to go over there because you know that it could be a real person or it could be an AI person that's just going to like laser you and destroy you in one shot. So it gets like pretty quickly intense as soon as a gunfight starts. So you could take it for leave it for that. Take it or leave it for that. But yeah, excited for the Streets of Tarkov whenever they do, or Streets rather, whenever they do decide to put that out there.
Great.
What do we think about Tiny Tina's Wonderlands? They started that with the show. Like, let's talk about it. It's interesting.
I'm not a huge, I like Borderlands. Like, Borderlands is kind of like Star Wars. Like, I like it. Am I a fan? Sure. Do I know, like, does it go any deeper than that? No. But, like, that actually, like, got me more hype than Borderlands 3 ever did.
Yeah.
That looked fucking fun and up my alley because, you know, it's D&D stuff, so.
Yeah. I guess I'm excited for it. I don't know. Borderlands 3 kind of left a bad taste in my mouth, even though I put a shit ton of time into it.
That's how I feel.
I wish we had a little bit of gameplay.
Yeah. Yeah. It's
my favorite Borderlands was the fucking Telltale one.
Yeah. Same here.
Same.
Yeah. That was great.
Story and humor wise, it was by far the most like nailing one. Like it just kind of nailed all that it did. It was actually really funny. Didn't feel try hard at any point.
Right.
Yeah. It was naturally funny.
Yeah.
That's Andy Samberg, Will Arnett, Wanda Sykes. Like, those are great names.
They're naturally funny people, right? Like,
they are.
Yep. That's the thing. If they can capture that lightning in a bottle and it's not a claptrap focused game in that sense, or he doesn't exist really, then it's already got a plus in my book, right?
It makes me really hope that those people were involved in like making the comedy and not just performing the comedy. Like, if that's the case, then I think that it could be really pretty good. It's also going to be interesting to see how much they tie it to Borderlands, because the fact that they're making it a standalone, is it going to be like the Tiny Tina DLC where there's just going to be like a little cutscene at the beginning with all the main characters of Borderlands 3, and then it just launches into what, a giant DLC essentially?
Yeah.
Or is it going to be like completely separate outside of Tiny Tina? How much are they going to connect this game to the franchise? So we'll have to see.
Yeah, I think she mentioned, Ashley Birch was on stage afterwards. I think she was mentioning that there's like new classes, they're going to have spells, was something that she made mention of that was a little different from kind of the general Borderlands algorithm, so to speak. So cool. I think that series needs that to, you know, it needs a refresh. It needs more than just guns with loot and different styles of those guns and all that.
So real quick, remind me, where's Butt Stallion from?
Borderlands.
Borderlands. But like, what was the part that it played?
I don't.
Butt Stallion was Handsome Jack's Diamond Unicorn or something, right? Wasn't that?
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
That makes sense. Yeah, that's. Yeah.
But by the way, was it belonged to Handsome Jack? That's all I needed.
Yeah.
Okay. I love the one guy in chat where that was like, it's not Borderlands, it's its own thing. Dude, it's going to be 95% Borderlands. The spells are probably just going to act like guns. Like, it's going to be Borderlands. Like, if you don't think it's going to be Borderlands, it's going to be Borderlands. So, I mean, I would, you know, going to have some little gimmicks and stuff, but it's going to be Borderlands.
It's going to be Borderlands.
Even the title is only two letters different from Borderlands.
Yeah.
Yeah, they call it Wonderland.
Maybe, like, it's going to be like Yakuza 7. Like, it's going to be the same feeling, but just new mechanics, new characters.
I don't think that different.
You don't think
so? I don't think they're... Well, here's the thing. Like, especially after seeing Borderlands 3, Gearbox really likes to cater to who they know is their core audience. And that is people that like looter shooters.
Yeah.
So my guess is that it's in their interest to keep it as much of a feel as Borderlands as they can while making it its own standalone thing. So I don't think they're going to try to be too different. Because they want those people to keep really enjoying it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. Schluter's trademark.
For sure. Was a little, I guess, it was nice to
make it a spinoff? Because they can charge $60 for it.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, exactly. Yeah. That's the reason. Or 70.
Or 70 these or 70, days. Yeah, right. Exactly.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of it was nice not to see Randy. You know, like I'm glad that he didn't do a magic trick there, right? Like,
high point of the announcement, no Randy.
I mean, like,
you know what would be awesome if this is a true like magic fantasy, high fantasy kind of thing. Like, maybe they cast like a resurrection on Catch a Ride.
Scooter.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He's a great character. very much makes that Telltale game worth playing for sure, without a doubt. Could be.
Maybe Speak with Dead, something like that.
Oh God, that would be cool, but also like very sad. That would be that one time in any D&D experience where Speak with Dead was actually like touching. Because most of the time you're like, hey, let's talk with this guy we just killed that has no purpose at all, and the DM's going to make a name up for him right now. Instead, let's talk with Scooter, a guy with a shit ton of backstory that is very well known. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have to be dark. It doesn't have to be like that. It can be like, it can make it funny.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I think anything.
They can make it super wholesome. Like maybe heaven for Scooter is exactly what you want it to be for him, you know, that kind of thing.
Okay, for a lot of people in chat are saying, didn't the voice actor die? No, from what I understand, I think the voice actor stopped voice acting. I don't think he died.
Oh. Okay.
Did he? I don't think he died.
I don't know.
I think something happened, and like I think he got a medical thing that made it so he couldn't voice act as much, and he left, I think.
Yeah, I'm getting mixed reports in chats. I'm getting he's sick.
Marco said, that's for Claptrap? No. The Claptrap guy, that was a huge issue. He got cut.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The new Claptrap guy came in. That's a completely different thing. Dude, he claims Randy... You know what? Let's not get into
this. Let's not do it. That's what I'm saying. It was nice for Borderlands.
You should Google what happened to the first Claptrap.
It was nice not seeing Randy. Because all that baggage that you're about to bring up, not even in the process. Someone in my chat said he had a stroke and is diagnosed with MS. But he is still currently alive. Ooh. So... Yeah, not doing too hot, but hopefully doing better than when all that stuff was diagnosed. I don't know his current status. So
I'm looking at that site you said with all the trailers and stuff. Very good site, by the way. Very cool.
Yeah.
There is something that I guess I must have looked away for, or maybe was only shown a clip of it. But there's a giant Silent Bob game called Chronic Blunt Punch.
Yep.
And it looks fucking cool. It actually looks pretty neat. It's a beat 'em up, but it looks cool.
That was at the Gorilla thing, Co. Is that where we saw that? I think that was on the Gorilla Collective on Saturday.
I think so.
Yeah. There's a lot of stuff in there, Zeke, that I think you would like if you want to scan those trailers for sure.
That's what I'm doing right now, yeah, for sure.
What do you guys think about that Death Stranding director's cut thing?
Honestly, I hate saying this. Waste of time.
Yeah.
I like Kojima said, really didn't say much for as much as he talked. And then this whole thing here was kind of just like, I guess it's a nod to Metal Gear Solid, but it doesn't make any sense for a director's cut. Like, I don't know. And then the amount of hype that they gave it for a director's cut. Like, I don't know, dude. Oh, kind of like a waste of time, especially for like the third thing at the show.
Yeah
I
hope Kojima's doing all right, you know. It seemed a little dour in that interview,
and I see people in chat were like, he was trolling, and it's like, okay, that's cool, but you generally want to reserve the trolling, maybe not for the third slot in a major showcase, and or make it really good trolling. It didn't really seem like great trolling. I don't know, it seemed a little weird.
Yeah,
we got like no details on to what director's cut means. Is that more content? Is it cut content? Is it maybe those interior places we saw? We don't really know.
Yeah.
Okay, now if people in chat are saying,
"What?"
Now wait a second. If that was Kojima hinting at a future Metal Gear Solid game or something, like if it turns out that this was some kind of like message, that could be. I didn't get that from it, but maybe that's what some folks are saying. That could be,
I don't think,
weird. I don't know.
Well, like, I mean,
some kind of foreshadowing, but this was weird too, because I'm 90% sure that's not in the game.
Yeah.
Are they saying that this is going to be in the director's cut?
I don't know.
What I wanted to know is, why are they calling it director's cut? I thought the whole reason Kojima did, like, went on his own, did all that shit, was so he could have, like, pretty much total control over his project. And is this saying like the original, like what came out wasn't his vision, like for the game?
Also, those soldiers there are, again, not in the base game at all. Like whatever those little tassel-y predator looking things are, that's not even in the game. So it's like, did they cut a whole faction that they're putting in? I don't know, dude. The whole thing was a little weird. It's just a little weird.
It's a little strange.
So many questions.
It would have made more sense if they announced a DLC or something.
That's what I thought. It was DLC. Yeah, when it first showed up.
Yeah.
It does look Metal Gear. I agree. It looks Metal Gear. It looks like Metal Gear.
Yep.
I guess I just don't like the term director's cut in lieu of something that might be more complete extended. Director's cut seems like he didn't have control of it, the first release of it. But yeah. I played the game. It certainly felt like it was Kojima all the way through.
Right.
Also, the more you think about it, okay, he hacks into an underground area. He looks at a vent. He walks up to patrolling guards. He jumps in a box. Like, there is absolutely no question he's alluding to Metal Gear.
Totally.
You can't say he's not. But then at the same time, it doesn't go anywhere for Death Stranding. So it's kind of like, and then he puts the box back on the shelf. That's supposed to mean something?
With the tone that interview was in, I wonder how much of this was him trying to say, like, I really miss Metal Gear. Right? Like,
maybe
I really miss making that game that I made five of that everyone really loved, but here's the director's cut of this game.
Maybe it was just a middle finger.
Could have been.
maybe that's all it was, dude. Cause that I would not put it past him, like, just to be like, I can make Metal Gear, I just won't call it Metal Gear, fucker. Watch.
does it say anything on that pad, by the way? Can you go back to the beginning and pause it on that? Metal Gear,
the name, right?
Which pad?
Oh, what does it say on that little pad by the door?
Is there, RDY.
Is that ready. Little writing legible? I would not be surprised if he hid like stuff.
Let's
in
go frame by frame.
Mm-hmm. Frame by frame analysis. We need to enhance. Can you enhance? Do you have that technology?
Let's get top men on this.
Top men. Well, we already have you here, Dan.
Let's go. Let's hear it. Hold on. Yeah. Let's do this properly. Let's go full screen. Code duck. Code duck. We see anything, guys? What are we thinking here?
Oh. Enhance! Can't see shit, Captain.
JP, hit the enhance button.
I don't have a button for enhance, Captain. I think it
in
just
the
says,
movies, they just like zoom in, it starts clearing it up. I
think it says config. I mean, if we're doing this, right? Hold on. What does it say? Configuration? What are we looking at here? I don't think it's legible.
Next Metal Gear 2022? Is that what it says?
I think that's what it says. Yeah. Yeah. Is this 4K? Oh, I don't know if this has 4K. Granted, this is from Games Radar, so this might have been from the stream.
Mm-hmm.
So. Oh, okay.
Wait. Look at that. No, if you look at the outline in the very bottom right, sponsored by Kashap. What's Kashap?
I don't know. Who could say? Yeah, a weird thing. Just wholly strange. But we'll see. Someone in my chat said that there's more information on that next week. I don't know where that came from, but
maybe Sony's will share something during one of their things. It looks like it's going to be on PlayStation.
Yeah. If anything, it might just be PS5 and that's it. Like the director's cut.
Trending on Twitter. It's real. No reference to a game, no reference to anything. Just, it's real is trending on Twitter right now. That's great.
That's great.
Not even a reference to Elden Ring.
It's got to be thinking about the Elden Ring devs. It's got to be pretty cool to like put that out at this point and like see the reaction before and afterhand and everyone just like losing their shit.
Especially the people that have been sitting on it for like years now. Totally. Like two years they've been sitting on like all those cool things they're working on and... Wow, man. Impressive.
Yeah. Got to be really, I hope a camera's on them in some way, to like see the reactions. Cause that, if that was it, like another thing that also kind of sucks, the fact that there was no audience there. We didn't get to see like people freaking out and kind of like vibe off of that.
Yeah.
The cheering of like an E3 event makes me kind of miss a big E3 deal, but also maybe not True. Miss it because there would have been cheering for other stuff.
Well, yeah. I'm kind of glad because it's you hear the awkwardness of like, this is a new game that no one's heard about. Here we go. And they're like, oh, I don't know what I'm clapping for. Like, I don't know what we're going to show.
Yeah.
And then like, or other games that people just aren't super excited about. They're like really lukewarm. And then Elden Ring, everybody just loses their fucking mind.
Well, again, I mean, this fits the co rule of if I like it, they're allowed to cheer.
Sure. Right?
So this would fit naturally with, you know, the games that I like. So here's a little bit of the Lost Ark stuff. Did they say when? Was there a date attached to when this is going to be like streamable, playable, alphable, whatever?
I don't know for sure, but I saw people in chat saying something about October. I don't know if they said that during the trailer or if that's been like leaked or something. Fall 2021, that's saying.
Okay.
Just, oh, it actually said, Steam says fall 2021.
Gotcha. According to the sign-up page, it says the alpha starts tomorrow. I don't think the alpha is streamable. However, I do
think... No, I don't think it is either.
Chat saying DetMods is playing tomorrow on stream, so I assume that's probably Bikeman as well.
Awesome.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Definitely check that out.
DetMods is playing tomorrow. Bikeman's doing 2 hours of play this Saturday. So yeah, it is NDA'd, except for the partnered streamers or whatever they're going with for that.
Little snippets of gameplay.
Totally. Yeah. Cool stuff. Let me just do one more look through. God, that Overwatch thing was real weird.
Embarrassing.
It was real weird. It wasn't even a trailer. They like wheeled him out there to talk about Overwatch 2 skin changes. And that was it. So that was kind of weird. Kind of strange. Personal interest, Tales of Arise. That looked great. I'm more excited for that game every time I see it. Looks good. And then Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout stuff with Nier was pretty silly. And then that Tribes of Midgard game. That one was one that I don't think anyone knew about going into it. And it actually looks pretty fun. That like ARPG yeah. Valheim game.
That's one I would definitely want to try. It seems like
it looks great.
What Fortnite was originally trying to do. It seems like it could be really fun.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll pull up a little, I got some like Attack on Titan vibes from the end of it. With how big those
big gods looked or Titans looked really cool.
Yeah.
Also, it seems kind of fun that they added, you know, with the nighttime getting attacked thing. I mean, you could get attacked in Valheim, but you never really had like a reason to build a big base, you know, outside of those kind of rare attacks. So if being attacked is going to be a central feature, like kind of like in 7 Days to Die, it would give a lot more credence to building like a big structure and like a big base and stuff, which could be really cool. It also looked like at times there were defensive emplacements and like things you could put on I think like trebuchets or something or catapults or I don't know what they were, but they looked awesome. Ballista maybe. Looks like the knights could be really fun.
Yeah.
I wonder how many players can play on a server.
PC Gamer article is saying it's up to 10 players.
Ooh, okay.
So, that's cool.
Yeah.
I can imagine just like monsters coming from all directions and players having to split up and cover each of the corners of the map and working together. It could be really, really fun.
Sure. For sure. I think
there's like good farming and you know, a lot of RNG in the items and a cool inventory and item system. That could be a real winner.
Yep. Yep. I think that Salt and Sacrifice, we should probably mention that. It was Salt and Sanctuary was the first one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. So they're getting a sequel that looked pretty much like Salt and Sanctuary 2 should look. Looks better graphically, better animated. And the fights look really cool. Also, co-op was announced in that trailer as well. And then the Metal Slug Tactics game, which was the second game shown, that had a really cool trailer to it with like the, I don't even know what 80s art style kind of sliced in. Hopefully that goes beyond the trailer and is, how the game is presented, story wise as well. That looked really cool. We didn't see, I'm trying to think of the rumors and supposed leaks that we were supposed to see. We didn't see the Firaxis game that everyone was saying was going to be there. The Firaxis like Marvel game. That was not there. What else is there that we try to remember if there was any other big rumors from yesterday that we said was going to be there, but I don't recall. No Kingdom Come Deliverance 2. That was in the trailer though, for the announcement of the publisher titled Prime Matter. That was in that Prime Matter shirt, as well as, Payday 3, I think was in there as well.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. So
also Outward. I mean, hopefully we're going to see more Outward stuff. They released a big DLC recently where you could like literally build a little town.
Yeah.
Which was really cool. Ooh, so I don't know if they're going to be doing more for that game, but if they do, we're on board. I think maybe one more DLC, but yeah, that game is fantastic for those that haven't played it.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of stuff shown in the Prime Matter, publisher trailer that they put out. I think Prime Matter is under Koch Media, according to my chat. So we'll probably see a lot more of them.
They're already sending out emails.
Oh, they are. Okay. Is that Saturday? When's the Koch Media stream?
Tomorrow. That's right.
Yeah. Is it tomorrow? Let me open up the schedule here real quick. We'll kind of go through it.
Yeah. It's Friday at noon Pacific.
Yep. 3 p.m. Eastern. So tomorrow, the stuff that is announced, at least Summer Game Fest stuff, New World Deep Dive at 11 a.m. Eastern. Netflix Geeked Week at 12 p.m. Eastern, Tribeca Game Spotlight. That Tribeca Game Spotlight is supposed to have, is it Koro? What is that PS5 game that was indie that they showed at like a State of Play a while back? Kena, that's what it's called. Kena will be there in some capacity at the Tribeca Game Spotlight. And then Koch Primetime. Everyone loves it. Everyone loves the Koch Prime Time. Zeke and Co are doing sponsored Koch streams tomorrow. Oh, Dan, you're doing a Koch stream as well.
Yeah,
oh,
you want to join us? Oh my God! You want to join us?
Yeah,
I'm doing it by myself. Me and Zeke are going to watch it. Do you want to join me and Zeke?
We can sure. Like a, yeah, that'd be fun.
Three-way. Oh. Let's do it.
Yeah, we'll do
everyone it. Three-way on Koch. This is gonna be fantastic.
No Koch is too many. You know what I'm saying? Wait.
I don't know if that works. It's not necessarily true.
Yeah.
There are
limits to the cock. Okay, there's limits.
Yeah,
too.
I think the length of this cock is going to be just right.
Okay. Yeah.
How about? Right, we're gonna have a cock party.
Yeah, cock party tomorrow. I'm not invited though to the cock party.
No, JP, I'm sorry.
This you guys is just are getting paid to be at the cock
for me,
party.
Dan and Zeke.
It's just I'm not.
Mm-hmm. All right, well,
depending
on what gets shown, like there might be some words, like angry words. So I don't want to avoid now, a cock fight.
Yeah. Oh,
JP, you know, I mean, if you wanted to be there for free, we could open the back door to our cock party if you wanted to come in.
I don't know. I don't want to say anything against the cock that's going to get, you know, cocks angry at me. I don't like angry cocks.
Yeah.
Okay.
So. I know you guys got to butter up the cock tomorrow.
Thank you for joining us for a session of Hallelujah.
Okay, all right. He had one more. I knew he had one more. He was like, how can I put like buttery cocks in there?
I'm more of a ball guy, really, if we're talking about, you know.
We would like to thank all of you for being here for How to Lose a Sponsorship in 2 minutes with your host, Meezy.
No shit.
That was fantastic. Thanks for being here. Thank you.
Oh God. After that is the IGN Expo that wraps up Friday. Saturday and Sunday are the biggins. If you want all of this information and don't want to hear me read it, by the way, I'm using the schedule at jpedia.net. There's a ton of different schedules out there. But my mods have put it all into a doc that we've been using. The Guerrilla Collective Day 2, 11 a.m. Eastern on Saturday. Then the Wholesome Direct at 1, Ubisoft Forward at 3. Dan, are you, you're joining us for, oh, you're joining us on Sunday.
Square Enix.
Yeah. We will not see you on Saturday. Devolver Max Pass Plus is now the name of that conference. That's at 4:30 PM. Gearbox Entertainment afterwards, Game Beat sessions, Game Beat and Koch Media should get together. Upload VR Showcase, will be on Saturday. And then Sunday's the big day with Xbox and Bethesda, 1 PM Eastern, followed by Square Enix at 3:15. And then the PC Gaming Show at 5:30. I think Square Enix is going to be very packed. I think there's going to be six of us on the show that day. It's me, Zeke, Co, Rami, Dan, and Jesse. We'll be covering the Square Enix Presents. Mm-hmm. So, we're gonna have to hold up cards and not talk over each other.
A lot of collaboration.
It is. It is.
I thought I was not in that. Honestly.
Oh. Okay. I'm not gonna fight you,
Zeke. I will respectfully free up more space.
We've got five people for Square Enix Presents.
Still a lot of people.
Still a lot of people. Yeah. Yeah. And then Dan will continue to join us for the PC Gaming Show on Sunday. Monday, we've got kind of the rest of the games. Verizon and Television, Take-Two Interactive, Mythical Indie Showcase, Freedom Games, Vin, Limited Run Showcase, Capcom will be there. And then Tuesday, Nintendo is shutting it down bright and early at noon Eastern. Elspeth, Luxie, Rami, and myself will be covering that. And I think Bandai Namco will also be doing some stuff later that evening, so probably some more Tales of Arise, which I will most likely be watching as well. Are we going to cover that awards show? I think I'm doing that solo, right? Co, you're out for that.
What time is it?
I think it's late. It's 7:45 Eastern on Tuesday. That's past your bedtime.
Is that the one I'm going to be chopping heads on? I think you might be chopping heads during that time. Might be chopping heads on that one. We'll see.
Yeah.
Put me down as maybe.
Yeah.
RSVB, pay me.
Oh, maybe. Also, Mr. Moogleberry, thank you for reminding me. I think tomorrow or maybe Saturday, we're going to have some Drop Frames merch, a shirt that will be going on sale. I think me, Co, and Zeke should have it in our hands tomorrow-ish, so we can show that off. It's just a shirt. Very simple. Very simple design. But someone approached me, and I said, yeah, sure, we'll do that. So that'll be up this week. We'll have more details on it, and I'll tweet about it from the Drop Frames Twitter. But
and the best part about it, all of the proceeds for the shirts go directly into our pockets.
Yes. Accurate. Yeah. I'm just going to keep saying yeah until I fix the shout-out cards. I think we're good to go. Zeke, you want to start?
That's a good cause, Co. It's a great cause.
It's a fantastic cause.
I got a new house, man. I got to pay for it.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll buy something. Zeke, go ahead. Do some shout-outs.
I would love to. Hello, everybody. My name is Ezekiel III. You can find me at @Ezekiel_III on Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube. But you can't find me on the Square Enix showcase. And especially now, because Barry is really upset because he made overlays for it already.
You know, Barry. Yes. I'll tell that story when you're finished.
I love you, Barry. Anyway, I will be... Actually, I'm going to be streaming after this. I was debating it, but... some plans switched around, and I'm going to be checking out that point-and-click game that I saw on Indie Day a few weeks ago called Strangeland. It looked awesome. We're going to start over from the beginning again by the Wormwood Studios and Wadget Eye Games. So we're going to play that for this afternoon for a few hours if you want to come stop on by. And then tomorrow we're going to all look at cock, and then... maybe some more gaming after that. So that's what's coming up E3 weekend. So thanks, Dan. Thanks, Co. Thanks, JP. That's all I got.
Awesome stuff. Co, shout outs.
Hi, everybody. My name is Co. As always, big thank you to JP and Zeke, and also a special thank you to Mr. Dan S. Gaming, Dan's Gaming, for being here. Looking forward to our further adventures over the course of this weekend. I will be playing some Chivalry 2 tonight at 6:30 p.m. Tomorrow morning, I think we're going to check out Final Fantasy VII Integrate. We also have Ratchet and Clank coming down the pipeline, probably some Guilty Gear Strive at some point, much more Chivalry 2, and of course, all the fun and adventures with the E3 stuff this weekend. So hope to see you here. Thank you, as always, for watching today, and we will see you for all the fun stuff this weekend.
Mr. Dan S. Gaming, when would you like me on your stream for Final Fantasy? When do you want to do this?
You can pick.
Probably okay.
Sometime this summer would be great. There's a lot of usually drought in the summer.
We'll chat.
I am Dan's Gaming, variety streamer on Twitch. Currently, I'm playing through the new Ratchet and Clank game. I got access today. I'll be doing a little bit more of that tonight. If you guys want to check that out, I'll be watching E3 stuff all weekend and joining these guys again on Sunday. So if you Thank you again for having me on the show. I love coming on Drop Frames. Zeke, Co, and JP are great people, and I love hanging out with you guys.
We like you coming on us. The show. Thanks, Kaido. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You know, I was going to do shout out.
These Dans won't stop coming. Okay.
See you guys tomorrow, probably. I'll be live. I'm continuing the stream on my channel, but we'll be going offline on their channel, and we'll figure out what I'm doing then. You know what? I'm just gonna end the stream. I'm not gonna make another cock joke. All right, I'll have a good one. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye.
Those are hard to follow. God damn.